approve this message.
Halito, everyone, Halito. Epetiwaste, Shalom, whatever your greeting. Halito, Renee, Damien, Davina Bolden, Halito, everyone. I just sent the link to Chisa now. So I just come to go on and get the chat built. Play some music till they get here, y'all. I thought I was gonna be running late. I ran to play the lottery. You can't win if you don't play. So let me get over here. I'm going to close. And share. Halito, Tony. Halito, Courtney. Hold on, y'all. Let me see what I'm going to play. Halito, everyone, hold on. Just give me a second. I'm shout y'all out as
like the river I've been running ever since. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. It's been too hard living, but I'm afraid to die. I don't know what's up there beyond the sky. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes it will. I go to the movie and I go downtown. Somebody keep telling me don't hang around. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. Then I go to my brother and I say, brother, help me, please. But he winds up knocking me back down on my knees. Lord, every time that I thought I could last for long, but now I think I'm able to carry on. It's been a long time coming, but I know change gon' come. Oh, yes it will.
Zariah, come here one more time. Okay. I'm sorry, y'all. Let me shout out everybody before I go and play my next tune. Alito, Chief Son.
Alito, Chris. Alito. Who else is on?
Nobody is. I sent it to you to send to them.
Okay, let me send it to them.
Okay, okay. All right, I'm going to shout out everybody while you do that.
All right. I'll be right there. Hold on.
I'm going to play another song.
All right.
Okay, Ari Soul, Darlene, Courtney, Shamel, Empress Awakening. How you doing, sis? I hope you're feeling better. Tony Furlow, Diva Glam. Hey, sis, how you doing? Sharanda, Jaguar. Darlene, I think I got you. Tony, Alito, Brandon, Alito, Pony Locks, how you been? Am I? Alito, Info Dot Wise, Alito, my brother, Alito, Johnny Avar. Hey, brother, how you been? I think that's everybody. I'm gonna play another. I'm a mute you, Chief, while I go play another song.
Okay, babe.
And Patty White, and Patty West Day, Stephen Red Clay, my brother. Buzzo. Okay, y'all. Let me run over here.
Gonna go get that mole checked. Gonna call the dermatologist tomorrow.
I will be one of the greatest, that is a vow, yeah, that is a promise. Always wanted to be famous, just being real, yeah, just being honest. My haters won't always be nameless, give them no clout, I give them no power. Creators built different, they ancient, sooner than later, all will be ours. I keep an eye out for the numbers, I stay in contact, synchronization. To infinity, even beyond it, I am a common, no destination. A lot of things I am above, and there are a lot of things that are above me. Do not come for the people I love, cause then I get scary, then I get uglier. Ain't no problem. I'm the equation, presence, loaded, observation. I'm not new here, reborn, creation. Come and find me, standing location. Ain't no problem, and I'm the equation, presence, loaded, observation. I'm not new here, reborn, creation. Come and find me, standing location.
so much more than a mindset. Gotta start right now, gotta change it. Can't take it all back, or save it. Know what you touch, just say it. Don't get your eyes equated. Time to break down the matrix. They don't get the mind of matrix. Their message is clear, it's better. It's better.
Just being real, just being honest. Just being honest. I will be one of the greatest, that is a vow, yeah, that is a promise. That is a promise. Always wanted to be famous, just being real, yeah, just being honest. Just being honest. With Metro by T-Mobile, make your
deep in my soul. Oh.
All right, everyone. You said she got it.
Yes, I shared it to her number. She told me to share it there, and I shared it. She said she got it.
Okay.
So I guess she's gonna come in.
All right.
I'm a little sad. I'm a little sad.
I know. You said that was your best friend.
That was my son's, one of his best friends.
Oh.
Yeah, his name was Sundiata.
Oh, that's sad. I'm gonna go through and holla, shout out to the people I didn't get to shout out.
All right, guys.
Okay. Let me go see if I miss. Okay, no, I got you, Johnny Everhart. I got you, Tony Furlow, my cousin Stephen Redclay. Want to say Soyo. I ain't gonna mess that up. Is it so? So Yopa, you 8811, you know I'm talking to you, Alito. Oh, King Benji. Rihanna Leon, I think I got you too, sis. Smoke Signal. Who else I haven't got? Michael, Alito, my brother. Brendan Rogers. Who else I have? Lito. Miss Nita, how you doing? Since I haven't seen you. Well, I seen you the other day. That's right, Dizzy. Let me see who else. Halito, sis. Halito, Miss Lita. How you doing? Charles Johnson. Halito, my brother. Who else have I missed anybody? Copper Color Goddess. Halito, how you doing? Okay, let me see. Anybody else? Halito Rainstorm, how you doing? Copper colored gal. Halito, how you doing? Halito Sagittarius Jones. Halito, how you doing? Chris Johnson. Halito, peace to you. Peace to you, free spirit. I think I got everybody. OG Green Machine. My thing just sped up, so I don't hope I haven't missed anybody. Halito, sis. Halito, Frida. Halito, Dog, Chief Dog Bull. Let me see, make sure I haven't missed any. Okay, I got it. Let me go back down there. It jumped. I think I got everybody. Halito, Kazozo. Halito, Cherokee. Halito, sis, how you been? Okay. I think it's everybody. I think Jessica, Martin, Halito, so how you doing? I want to say, if I missed y'all, charge it to the head, not to the heart. Welcome everyone. We waiting on Papa Tone, Halito, how you doing? We waiting on Clan Mother Mimi and Palmer J. Salute Executive Session. How you doing, my brother? We're waiting on them to come in, or if there's anything you want to speak on. I know you just y'all just also different in your family, and this is what's really, really why we said we have to get back to us, because our people are so lost. They're killing each other, you know. They don't target the enemy, they target each other. You know, something, if a person ain't killed or took somebody in your family or molested or raped somebody in your family, why are you out here killing? You can't give that life back. You cannot give that life back. You taking people and you don't want to go do the time. This is the problem with our people. They want to commit the crime, but they don't want to do the time.
It's sad. It's like some parts of our life is awesome because I see so many wonderful things happen, and then this type of thing happens, and it lets you know how vulnerable you can be, you know, how vulnerable things is if we don't get it together, man.
And that's a fact. I was listening to a live earlier. You know, my thing is a lot of people don't want to separate themselves from the I call them the $5 foot loans. Y'all know Lean Lean. That's who I call them. A lot of people, reason why we haven't moved forward and we still have this government playing these games like they had alive today with this bullshit they doing. The reason why we haven't moved forward because we're still looking for Lean Lean on our tree. Lean Lean is not on your tree. You're not them and they're not you. I know a lot of people, listen, if the shoe don't fit, don't put the motherfucker on. So don't say I'm trying to target you. So if it don't fit, please don't put this goddamn shoe on. The thing is, we are looking for foreigners to be on our fucking tree in order to make us the motherfucking American Indian. This is the reason why we haven't gotten any farther, because you're still looking for a foreigner on your trip. You ain't looking for the foreigner, aka Ling Ling now. You're looking for Jesus.
And it looked like we're trying to get everybody to accept us but ourselves. Exactly. I don't get it. You know, we ought to be tired of that, of putting ourselves last for everybody else.
Exactly. Because you're literally still trying to join these people. You're trying to be a part of these five civilized tribes. Those are not your people. In order for you to be able to move forward, do your genealogy. And you will see, you know, I just told Frida, it's funny how y'all looking for these people to be on your trip. Ain't never seen none of these people at none of y'all family reunions. You ain't seen none of these people at the family reunion because they're not y'all. These are imposters. Imposters. I know it's kind of hard because you've been indoctrinated and they've been showing you the crying Indian and keep talking about these people on these reservations and how they are suffering. But what about us? It's funny how we always want to bring people into our suffering, but nobody else speaks about our suffering. And we always got to speak about somebody else's suffering. It doesn't make any sense to me. Nobody cares about you, but they want you to care about them.
And you got to watch what you say about everything, but nobody watch what they say about us. I'm tired of it, and I'm tired of us trying to jump through hoops to be accepted by everybody. Except your goddamn self.
Exactly. We literally got people out here promoting the Native American as the original people, and that's a lie. And I tell them and the government in their face, they are telling bald-faced-ass lies. You've been lying to my people. You have reclassified my people. Y'all have came over here now. You placed my people in projects, aka hoods, because they're not motherfucking ghettos. Ghettos came up out of Germany. Leave it in Germany. You have allowed, we have allowed these people to come here and tell us who the hell we are. Yeah, we're divided. We're divided in so many ways. But a lot of division has to do with our own people. Because we got people that thinking they're African Americans. No such thing as two continents. That's not a nationality. You got people thinking there are many things, but except the original people. The original people of this land. Some call them American Indians. I'm going to call them Aborigines. Some people calling themselves Moors. You have a lot of division going on, but no solutions. You know, I told y'all, I don't argue over fucking titles. If you know who you are, you done your genealogy, who the fuck am I to tell you that you're not? Because guess what? I don't see nobody going up there telling those natives that they're not American. But you're quick to come over here in this community and tell people that they're not the American Indians, that they're not the ancient ones, descendants of the ancient ones. I see nobody but you will take on this title as Black and African American, which has no standing in law. You are placing yourself in a jurisdiction of a government. So how the fuck do you expect to move forward? You got people running around here that you holler, they are oppressing you, but you still want to be a part of that system. Same people that you claim that are oppressing you, you still calling yourself what they called you when they start reclassifying you. I literally hear people all day long, and then you will hear people say, no, Black was used before them. That's a goddamn lie. That's a goddamn lie. You niggas. Niggas are in their own way. Nobody's in your way but niggas. Self-hating ass niggas. Niggas want to argue over a title that a fucking Caucasian gave him. He reclassified you so he can take the land. So he can reclassify you to say that you're not American. That you're a slave when knowing damn well there's plenty of proof that these people came by way of a steamship over here to America. And the only thing they can give your ass is a motherfucking drawing. They'll talk about motherfucking Andrew Jackson, but then show you pictures of the shit that happened during Andrew Jackson when he was in his turn. Real pictures. Not no motherfucking drawing, but they'll give you a drawing of Andrew Jackson. You have to make this make sense at this time. You are willing to let a people that don't give two fucks about you to keep misleading you. Right along with them, you have the gatekeepers, because they benefit from your ignorance. They won't say that they're helping you. They want to say they want to see you better, but all you're doing is donating to their cause. And that cause is to keep them riding in motherfucking big beans, big bodies, and living their motherfucking best life while you still suffering. Do you plan on suffering for another 100 motherfucking years is what I want to ask.
That's bullshit, because that's why I feel I'm on this planet, to stop that suffering. I'm sorry. It's over. I refuse to allow my people to suffer anymore.
Facts. Like I tell y'all, if it ain't to better us, I don't want to have nothing to do with it. I hear a lot of people calling truth. Seen a lie today where people call it, and I have no problem with y'all calling truth, because I've been telling y'all I can't stand division. But I tell anybody, look, everybody should have a table when it comes to saving our people. You just won't sit in my table. Everybody don't think the same, and everybody don't feel the same way about my people the way I do. I don't need no motherfuckers that's wishy-washy. One minute you think you want to save the people, the next minute you just thinking about your goddamn pockets. You're thinking about being goddamn famous. Why are people still gunning down each other? They still out here goddamn it raping and pillaging their own people just as well as the goddamn foreigners. So no. I don't want to sit at the table with everybody. I don't mind them having a table, because I'm not that type of person. But what you will not do, and sit at the table with me, because only dealing with righteousness. And I'm telling you that right out. Everybody would not sit at my table.
How you gonna sit at the table with somebody or sell or stab you in the back?
That part.
There's no loyalty. There's no loyalty, man. People
no loyalty.
Minute. Hell with that. I know about being loyal.
Exactly. I don't deal with that. You know, my thing is, coming up as a child, I never dealt with that. If I don't fuck with you, I don't fuck with you. I don't have to say shit to you. You can live your life, I'm going to live mine's. And that's how it should be. We don't have to disrespect each other. You just don't fuck with me, and I just don't fuck with you. We don't have to be disrespectful.
Facts. An Empress Awakened, they can call you a cult all you want, baby. Bloodline can't be a cult.
That part.
Bloodline cannot be a cult.
Exactly. How is it it's a cult when it comes to us saying who the fuck we are, but everybody else has a nationality? It's okay for you to say you black and African American, but there's no such thing in fucking law for these people. There's no land for motherfucking African American. There's no motherfucking goddamn language for African American. And there's damn sure no motherfucking flag for the African American. There's no damn land for the blacks, no language for the blacks, and no flag for the blacks. But all the rest of them motherfucking nationalities have all three things that they benefit from. They benefit from this.
That's right. They benefit from it, Empress. So right.
But you niggas and people that don't know shit want to call it a cult. How the fuck us going out teaching people that this is their lane, it's a cult? Now that shows you the comfortability, and niggas that really believe that they are black. And they'll look at their goddamn skin and it be brown all goddamn day long, nigga. Your hair may be black, but your skin ain't. I've heard black hair, but I've never seen that could be the richest, darkest chocolate it is, but they still not black. And that's just called indigo. They still a deep-rooted chocolate. These are facts. Y'all allow people to come over here that's running a corporation. They here for business, then start meddling in your business. They have no business meddling with nothing that pertains to the indigenous people of this land. You have, like I asked y'all yesterday, tell me why the so-called Negroes that they want to call it, aka African Americans, why are y'all spreading all out over America? You the one they supposed to have captured. and brought over here by a slave ship. Why is it you spread it out and you're not on the reservation? Because the goddamn so-called Native Americans, they're on the reservation. This was with England, remember? Why the fuck you in the fucking corner some goddamn way? If it's your land, why are you on a corner? You have to make this shit make sense at that part right there, freedom. Make it make sense. Why the niggas that they claimed they brought here by the motherfucking boatloads, goddamn it, spread it all over America. But the motherfucking natives that claim that this is their land is staked in the goddamn reservations. And they all talking about how ran down the reservation is. But they done tore down your projects and bitch y'all up motherfucking condos and shit. Now why they ain't living in the goddamn condos? You still have to make this make sense. Oh, because the 1968 Civil Rights Act for housing. Like I showed y'all almost a month ago, those videos of our people being hosed down, bitten by dogs. They had to stand in the line for colors only, bathroom, restaurants, everything for color only. They had nowhere to live because during World War One, Two, and Vietnam War, they brought in migrations of their own people by the hundreds of thousands. While our men was out thinking they was fighting a real war, they was only allowing them to come into the fucking war because they wanted to inject them with poison. Oh yeah, United States, I know what you was up to. I told you, my ancestors never motherfucking lied to me. They give me so much shit in my sleep, I'd be just in my fucking sleep with you niggas. Because what you did was allow them to come into your army so you can inject them. Because you couldn't just go out and do it. They had to volunteer. Y'all still volunteering today. You volunteering today. No matter how much genocide they have caused our people, you still volunteering. You volunteer to join this fucking fake-ass corporation to fight battles that don't even exist. Just so they can inject you with bullshit. These are facts. Yes, it does, Stephen Redcliffe. Removes all doubt. Can nobody tell you who you are? Nobody. They have waged war on us from the moment they came and set up their fucking corporation. They waged war on the indigenous people of America, and it wasn't no motherfucking natives. Ask yourself, when you do your genealogy, you find land patents. Why the motherfucking goddamn Asian motherfucking natives ain't got the land patents if it's their land? Why the fucking Caucasians ain't got the land patent since they was the ones that first came here and took all the niggas off the coast of fucking West Africa? Why they ain't got the land patents? Shit ain't adding up no more motherfucking more. Nothing. Because guess what? They done lived their life for far too long. And you can only hide the lie for so long. Because you got to tell another lie to cover up the first lie. The niggas had done so much dirt and didn't keep up with the dirt they was throwing. The shit started showing. You got something to say, Chief Sunil, while we wait on Clay and Mother Mimi?
I'm in a room full of noise right now.
Okay, so. Okay. I'll continue. You know what? I can play while we waiting on Clan Mother Mimi to come. I can play another video of because we haven't got back videos. You know.
And remember my video I shared of my goddaughter.
Yes. Let me get off.
See, when something great like that happens, she's on two. Ain't too proud to beg the play about the Temptations. She's a dancer, she's a singer, and you see, you get positive stuff like that, and then I get a phone call about soup, and it's
it's heartbreaking. Hold on, Chief, hold on. Let me go over here and find this. Give me a second, everyone. Let me go over here and find this real quick. Hold on, y'all.
Yeah, this video Empress about to play is my goddaughter. Her name is Dariandra Tucker. And she was New Orleans born. She lives in New York now. She lives between the islands in New York. But this is her. Her name is Dari. We call her Dari. But that's my goddaughter.
Okay. Is the music playing? Hold on, yeah.
How to make the screen bigger, Empress?
Hold on. Yeah. I think so. Hold on. When I tried to, it made another box. I guess because it's through the what you call it. Let's do your messenger. Let me hold on.
You want me to send it another way?
Oh, he can say Mother Mimi, hold on. And Palmer.
Carlito, Carlito, grandmothers.
Carlito.
Palmer, I'm glad you made it safely.
Carlito.
Mimi is so awesome.
Oh, yeah, you know.
Beautiful. I love y'all so much.
Did y'all invite somebody else to come, y'all? Did y'all invite
somebody else?
It's just us.
Hey, no, are you inviting somebody? Oh,
baby. We got your grandbaby.
Yeah, here she is.
Hi, beautiful. Hey, beautiful.
Say Jalito.
Jalito, everyone. How y'all doing? You booking up?
Jalito.
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 I'll let y'all introduce yourselves.
All right, let me set it where. Okay. The one that's frozen. She frozen. Looks like we're all frozen.
Okay, hold on. Are we all frozen?
Beautiful grandbaby. Oh my God.
I'm just going to get a jacket.
Thank you.
Okay.
Look at that hair.
Sweetie. Hi. Hey. Say Jalito. Don't mess with the screen.
Hey.
How are you? Look at you.
Jalito.
Jalito.
She's busy. She is tearing up everything. Up here. We're in the park.
That's what it's about, these babies. That's what it's about, these babies.
Yes. That's what it's all about.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Okay, wait a minute. Wait a minute. I got to position the camera different. Okay. You can't be on the camera right now. I got to make it sit right.
You want me to email it to your Empress?
Which one? The video? Yeah, you can.
Okay.
And we'll play it at the end after we get through speaking. I really want to get into... I really want us to, you know, talk about what we talked about as far as trying to come together, bring the people together, you know, and what we can do about getting to Congress. Because I don't know if y'all seen that these fuckers was there again today with some dumb shit. you know, they want to. I mean, I later heard the school say that he was from Choctaw down in Mississippi, and how he was his relatives was ran out of. Nigga, y'all wasn't down here. We finna play this game, y'all. We're not gonna play this game.
They make up stories. They make up stories because they don't have one.
That's a fact.
You know what? And I tell them all mm-hmm. the time, like the lady at the store who said she was a Mississippi Choctaw, and she was from Choctaw, Mississippi. I said, hey, you know what? My mother was born and raised on the Choctaw, Mississippi. What do you call it?
Right.
She was raised there. I said, and most of the people in the second migration was raised there, and I don't remember them talking about y'all at all.
And what'd she say?
Well, she got mad and told us we wasn't Indians, not taxed.
What?
This was when we went to the store, Poma.
Yep. Target.
Yeah, Target. She worked at Target and she was pissed off.
She ran in that back room and she hid and she didn't come back out.
She told us to get out of her store.
Her store?
What?
Yeah.
You should have asked them, when did they come through Angel Allen?
Right.
That right then and there. When did your people start coming through Angel Allen? We never play no more games with none of these people. Not you or United States Corporation. It's a long time coming.
We got to push. You know, here's the thing that I'm realizing, you know, being that Article 1, Section 2, Clause 3 is part of a treaty. It's the Constitution is a treaty. It's a contract. And it has to be upheld. These Native Americans, who are, I decided, listen, let me tell you something. Before I go any further, I was calling them Native Americans. You know why? Because they're Siberian. So we should start calling them what they are. They're Siberian.
Thank you. You know, that's my favorite term for them, Siberian Huskies.
Siberians, that's what they are.
Yep.
Yeah. That's what they are. They're from Siberia. They're Siberians. They're Russians. Like, if somebody's from Africa, they're African. If somebody's matter where they're from, and I'm just tired of playing this game with them, they can call themselves Chief Cheetah for all I give a fuck. They still...
Chief Stonehead and shit.
Yeah, they still not from here. There's a whole lot of shit that will have to end. It's got to end now.
Absolutely. And
they know that we're the only ones who can end it because this is our land.
Yes, and that's why they continue to try to make us stay asleep, because they know once we do wake up and once we do claim what we, who we are and what we have, that's going to be it. Mm-hmm. It's over. It's totally over.
You know, if we have a good 50, we have a good 50 of us to go to Congress, that's a good number. Even if we have 25, we don't need 100. It's better to have 100, 200, 300, absolutely. Although to go to Congress, we have a good 50, a good strong 50. That's a great start.
Yeah, that is a great start. I'm working on it. Right now, I got 10.
Yes.
I got 10. And something else is happening. You know, there's a lot of these young people coming out of these Moorish groups, and they're saying to me, "Oh, you know, Mother Mimi, you warned us, you told us, you know, they're getting with these Moors. The Moors are getting land under them, and they're kicking them off the land." So now they're like, well, we didn't know. No, you did know, because I told you how many times to stop fucking with Moors.
Right.
Stop dealing with them. So well, now.
Why do you need them when you have your bloodline? I was trying to tell this young lady when I was, you know, dealing with the status correction thing. And she was telling me, well, that's the only way you're going to get out of it. I said, well, who says that? And I mean, she was like really nasty with me and cursed me out and everything, but I told her, I said, really? I stand on bloodline, sweetheart. I don't need to claim no religion.
That's right.
Because that's all that is. That's religion.
That's religion.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to try to find something for y'all.
Absolutely.
about these Moors. Y'all can keep talking. It ain't gonna take about a minute. It's a document somebody told me about. And I bet you anything Copper Empress know about it already.
What is
the Moore Sundry Act?
Stephen Ray, I've heard of it. Yeah, I heard of the Moore Sundry
Act of 1790. And here's what these Moors said. This is part of their petition.
Yes.
Can you guys see me?
Yes, we can see you.
Okay, I'm going to read this. It talks about the petition from the Sundry that they petitioned the United States. See, they have a contact with the United States, not with us. Mm-hmm. You know, so this is what they said to the United States. Where is it? Well, they said they didn't want to be treated. They didn't want to be like the Negro. That's what, here it says. The free Moors, Francis Daniel Hammond, Samuel petitioned on behalf of themselves and their wives, Fatima, Flora, Sarah, and Clarinita. I'm sorry, guys, my throat. They explained how some years ago, while fighting in defense of their country, they and their wives were captured and made prisoners of war by the Portuguese. After this, a certain Captain Clark had them.
I'm a mute you, and when you ready to talk, okay. Thanks, sis. Okay, go ahead.
Delivered to him, promising they would be redeemed by the Moroccan ambassador residing in England and returned to their country. Instead, he transported them to South Carolina and sold them for slaves. Since then, by the greatest industry, they purchased freedom from their respective masters. They requested that as free-born subjects of a prince in alliance with the U.S., that they should not be considered subject to a state law then in force known as the Negro Law. If they be found guilty of any crime or misdemeanor, they will receive a fair trial by a lawful jury. There's a bunch of these type of Moroccans where they say they don't want to be treated like Negroes. Here's another one down here where it says, I'm gonna make this one short. They have considered the same and are of opinion that no law of this state can be in its construction or operation applied to them, and that persons who were subjects of the Emperor of Morocco, being free in this state, are not triable by the law for the better ordering and government of Negroes and other slaves. You trying to tell me these niggas don't know they ain't us? Mm. That right there proved they know they ain't us.
Of course they know they not us. They're infiltrating just like the Siberians do.
Siberian Huskies. Just like
and
these.
Let me tell y'all, Indians not taxed, who are getting taxed by Moors, who are screwing you in the butt with a spiked penis. And then you come crying, talking about, ooh, you told me. You should be ashamed of yourself. You should be ashamed of yourself constantly giving your power to somebody else. That shit is over. Stop doing that. That's enough. We've had a few. We just stop being stupid.
That's right. Stop it.
Stupid.
That's right. If you can't rely on bloodline, you can't rely on nothing.
Right.
Your bloodline and your genealogy proves it all.
Yep.
And these people charging you an arm and a leg to do your genealogy. Hell, all you need is to get on what? Genealogy.com or go to the library.
Ancestry.com.
Yeah, stop being lazy.
They have a lazy too. That's right. They have a free one.
Can't nobody else find your lineage but you.
I ran into this lady the other day. She said she's a genealogist. Of course, I could tell she was mixed. So she hit me with her father is an Indian and her mother is a Caucasian. I said, it doesn't run on the father's side. It runs through the mother's side. We're matriarchal. She said, no, we're patriarchal. I said, no, we're not. We're matriarchal over here in America. They came and made it patriotic because it's all about the man on man any fucking way, because that's what it was about. But you know, I had a conversation alone because I think she got kind of bothered by the situation, because now she's saying, my mother is a Caucasian. You holds no titles, my girl. I'm not knocking you for your daddy. Yeah, you do have Indian in you, but you are the seed of your mother. Your mother carried that egg. Your daddy just fertilized it.
Mm-hmm. What do they say?
25.
They say you are who your mother is, right?
Yes.
And if we think, remember when they were invading us, they were raping us and marrying us,
yes,
killing our men. So who had the power? Who had the land?
That's why they was taking the men into their fake ass wars and fucking because it was to kill off the men so they can bring their men in and be able to lay with us so they can hold title to the land. But it didn't work like they thought it would work. That's what it was all about. My cousin Steve Red Clay said, why go to Congress when we can start up our own family tribe? We're not going to tell them or ask them nothing. We're going to tell them.
Let me tell you something. If it's a person who is light skinned, because my daughter is light skinned, Empress, you're light skinned. We came in all colors.
Yep.
So, but I'm not fooled by other foreigners coming here and then claiming that they're Native American. I can spot our people a mile off. Mm-hmm.
See, we want to go, we know we speak of starting our own tribe with our relatives. We definitely speak on that. But we want these motherfuckers to know we still here. We never went nowhere. All you did was reclassify us, and the Racial Integrity Act is proof that you reclassified us.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And you better stop. We want to get our own government, and we're going to do it. We're going to have our own government.
We have it. That's right. We got it. Let's manifest that. We got it.
Yes.
So all we have to do is execute it now.
But they only speaking because they want to continue to lie. They want the lie to keep going on for another 100 years while they finish killing us off. That's their agenda, is to take the lie and keep running with the lie.
As long as they can. Exactly.
As long as they can. People.
And all these people that's not, let's just go on. I don't know. Well, maybe I can say it because this is your show and I don't want to get show.
I got it, y'all.
But you know what? They sitting up here listening to these JEWs.
Yes. Call them small hats.
They can't be trusted worth the fuck. They want to tell everybody, people keep running us out of town just because we do. Now, people keep running you out of town because you keep fucking everybody in the ass.
You keep being evil.
They're evil. You know how many Aborigine people they have killed across the planet? Across the planet. There's stories about how they have gone in and poisoned and caused, what they're doing now.
Experimenting.
And sterilizing people. And
yes,
I just found out there was a whole African tribe that was sterilized by Bill Gates. Is it Bill Gates? Is that his name? Yeah
probably
a whole tribe with vaccinations. They'll never, they extinct. They just know they're extinct.
That's what they're trying to do to us. Have y'all noticed? Nothing starts to go extinct until these motherfuckers start goddamn it coming around.
Yep.
Life been going on forever on this planet until these motherfuckers start coming around on our fucking land. Then everything starts to go extinct with they fucking nasty, dirty asses.
Well, what does the law say about them? It says that they are monsters and should not have land. That's proof of that.
That's
they
right.
Don't know what to fucking do with it except to destroy.
That's it. And they're doing a very good job at that. Look, they cut down your trees. They are poisoning your water, your air. These are monsters. I don't care how you want to lay with them, how you want to justify being with these things, but these motherfuckers will never have respect for you, ever. They don't even have respect for their own goddamn people.
Yep. These Jews ain't nothing but monsters. That's all they are. And they sit up and they try to act like they care about us by telling us, oh, you know, what's his name, Herskovitz? I thought maybe he tried to find some kind of scientific proof that we was attacking Africa.
Mad science.
This motherfucker didn't find no proof. All he did was put a bunch of theories together and say, look, y'all attached to Africa. And they went, okay.
Yep. You let the last species that was grafted come and tell the first organic beings who the hell they are. Now, you have to make sense of this. They will find gold of the organic on every side of this motherfucking planet.
Mm-hmm.
And it damn sure ain't them.
That's right. Nope.
So, yeah, I was listening to what Pomaj was saying about just 50 of us can go to Congress. Well, we need to start planning that as soon as possible.
Yep. I've already started planning it. I'm gathering my people. I'm gathering my nation. I'm gathering them. I'm talking to them. I'm telling them. I'm teaching them. Mm-hmm. We're gonna have to stand. We got to stand in the law because these tricky motherfuckers are trying to do every other way but law.
Yes.
So I'm doing that. I'm doing all that I've learned.
You know what, with law, they coming with politics.
I'm sorry.
You should know this. By you being indigenous, you are the law.
I'm the law.
That's right. That's right.
Absolutely.
But they're rogue, and we have to remember that these people have no kind of conscience, they have no kind of heart, they have nothing as far as the compassion and stuff we have. They are insidious. So we need to keep that in mind too.
Mm-hmm.
And make sure our pen is mightier than their sword.
Mightier.
And we don't go anywhere without our warriors.
That's right.
That's right.
That's the key. The warriors are the key.
Yes.
We got to keep in mind, too, that these motherfuckers are very serious about trying to tell us or pull us into maritime law. Motherfucker, your court, listen. And I thought about this, I said, universe, you know, they really do have us bamboozled. We think that if we walk into their court and we automatically in maritime law, motherfucker, that court is on my land. That bank is on my land. Your court room is on my land. All those on my law. Fuck you with your goddamn maritime law.
That part.
That shit ain't even real. And we need to stand there and tell them, you can't judge me by some maritime law, motherfucker. I don't see no goddamn ships and water and seamen in here in this courtroom.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
We need to start telling them your shit is failing.
They know it. They just hope we keep playing along with the script. That's the problem. A lot of people want to play along with the script because they don't know who the fuck they are. They're literally it's so many channels y'all on fucking YouTube with this whole pro-black movement that ain't got their ass nowhere. They started this pro-black movement back when motherfucking Marcus Garvey. The shit ain't changed for you, nigga.
Sure.
It has never changed nothing in your reality. But you niggas still want to ride with this bullshit. Because some fucking elder said he went to Africa and found out your ass was African. Bullshit. Bullshit. You got all these powerful people speaking this fucking bullshit to our people with no fucking proof.
I just have one thing for them. Show me the proof. Show me the ship.
Yeah.
Show me my ancestors on them ships, and I'll be happy to claim that.
Yeah.
But until you do my genealogy for the last 15 years and find what I found, you can't tell me nothing.
That's right.
Shit.
Mm-hmm. That's exactly right. Mm-hmm. And how come Mexicans, excuse me, every time I talk to an African, a sensible African, not them dumbass motherfuckers.
Yes.
Come over here just trying to get our land. But every time you talk to a sensible African, first thing he says is this. Well, if we sold you into slavery, where are the receipts? Because the white man keep a receipt for everything.
That's right.
Every fucking thing. Don't need a goddamn receipt.
facts. And the sad part about it, these motherfuckers that all want to make like the weird of slaves that came, the Africans that believe the bullshit, then they'll say, we ain't sell y'all all. That's double standard bullshit. We didn't say that you don't want to be the ones that sold us all, but then you say that they came and took you from Africa.
Yeah.
The dumb shit.
That's dumb.
Yeah, no more waste. No more waste than shoe leather. I'm going to look them eye to eye. I want to look at them in their faces with our warriors right there.
Yep.
And let them know y'all are on our land and y'all got to go.
Everywhere the Caucasian European has went, all lands they have ever touched down, either they disappeared or their nationality changed. They are no longer the aborigines of that land. They become whatever the fuck these motherfuckers want to call them.
Yep.
But if you ask them, who the fuck are you and where the fuck did you come from? Some of you motherfuckers may be grafted here, but some of you motherfuckers, I think, touched down in 14 motherfucking 92. Some of you bitches, I think, goddamn it, came from some foreign motherfucking place outside this goddamn realm. I know a lot of y'all niggas don't want to speak on that shit.
Yeah.
It kind of bothers y'all, but everything that's walking and talking ain't what it is. One thing y'all need to believe in is the Mandela effect. Everything you see ain't what you really motherfucking see.
Mm-hmm. My grandmother told me that. Absolutely.
Yes. Yeah.
You always see these motherfuckers talking about they were pulled up in a goddamn spaceship. Yeah, bitch, because our people know who the fuck they brought here. They trying to figure out how the fuck you got here. They grown up here. Near one of us talking about a motherfucker that picked us up on the motherfucking lost ass road. Because they know who the fuck you are. They want to know who the fuck are you. And where the fuck you come from. That's the question. Where the fuck did they come from? I know we know the Yaku story. A lot of people know about the Yaku story. Okay, but some of these motherfuckers ain't what it really seemed to be.
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever listened to Young Pharaoh question this Jew?
Mm-hmm.
He let that Jew have it, and then he said, okay, we know we come from. Now, where do you come from? That Jew could not figure out how to answer them questions. He went round and round and round. Because think about it. He said, look, Adam ain't but 7,000 years old. We've been here for hundreds of thousands, maybe even millions of years. So how in the fuck did you get to be first?
That part. And that's another thing when you're dealing with the genetics. If you want to, these niggas want to talk about like they're so motherfucking supreme. Nigga, you are a recessive genetic. You do not give birth to the dominant. And then when you niggas want to come out with some new kind of fucking virus that you motherfuckers have created in a goddamn lab, the first thing you niggas want to do is give it to the dominant race. If you are the dominant race, that means your motherfucking DNA and everything about you, your motherfucking immune system, everything is dominant. You are not a weak genetic. They are the weakest genetic, and that's why all that shit is always on them. All they do is use they fucking bullshit and to create these motherfucking diseases that come off of their ass so they can put it in a motherfucking bottle and inject it into your ass.
Because hold on. Thomas Dotson, no, I don't. I know who I am. My grandmother, Mary Williams, is full-blooded Choctaw and is on the rolls, on the Baker, the Henderson, and the Gideon rolls. Not no dog rolls.
What happened?
She's on the Baker. No, Thomas Dotson said our aborigines think that we came from the Native Americans. No, we don't.
No. You may be talking about the ones that's coming new into the community. A lot of the ones that's coming new into the community, the reason why they haven't gotten anywhere, because they're still looking over here at Native American as being the indigenous people, and they are not the indigenous people, and they damn sure ain't the first motherfuckers here. No. We are.
They ain't native to this land.
At all. They ain't native to this
land. They ain't even indigenous to the motherfuckers. If you was aborigine while you was in Russia, what made you think you could come over here and be aborigine?
That part.
You can't even bring aborigine with you in a fucking suitcase. They
got the Dancing Rabbit Treaty. That's it. I don't know of any other ones, but I know all of the treaties, the 370 that we do have, those are our treaties. They have no treaties. Mm-hmm. Those treaties were written, and there's evidence to prove that in House Con no Senate Congress 76 lists all of the treaties that we have, and it's very clear that they're speaking about Article 1, Section 2, Clause 3 Indians. They're not speaking about Native Americans because they don't even use the term Native American in any of the treaties.
It sure
any of the 370, nor do they use the word Native, but rarely. And when they do, it says Natives of America.
That's right.
And when they do use Native it in that way. People. They don't say Native American. Natives of America. That's a different terminology. They ain't got no treaty. They have nothing to stand on.
Out of all the treaties that I read, it says said Indians. Said Indians.
Mm-hmm. Period.
And that means you have to declare who you are.
Mm-hmm.
And I was reading the document by them. I be coming across all kind of shit about them niggas are so desperate. I'm gonna call them niggas too, if you don't mind. Them niggas are so desperate. They're trying to find them to this land. And it's just ridiculous that it's so obvious that they can't find anything. That all they can do is get angry because they don't have anything else. If you don't have the law, then what else do you have? Every time you go somewhere, I know what I was about to say. They were complaining that they can't be found in the census. And we're doing the Choctaw, one of the reservations, that nobody, they're not in the census on the reservations. No, because you wasn't there.
Thanks.
Number one. So they're creating a little a reservation I ain't never heard of, and saying, "Well, we was here." And
why?
So they put a few little white people on there. You know, they said that when they came to us, they classified us as white. Well, mm-hmm. They didn't classify us as white because look, we don't look white.
Mm-hmm. Really, white and black.
You a Caucasian.
Mm-hmm. But the thing is, white and black is a status. It's not even a skin color. White is a higher status. That meaning like us, we are the pure. We are the organic. We are higher status. These are peasants, squatters, whatever you want to call the lowlifes, the beggars, the bombers. That's the motherfuckers. They came here with one motherfucking bag of clothes and couldn't even speak English. Couldn't write their own motherfucking name, but all of a sudden they said these niggas out taking census. Taking what census, niggas? We don't owe you shit. You own our land. Yep. We need to be taking census of your motherfucking ass because the moment you stepped on these shores, bitch, you came over here to the landlords.
Yeah.
We are the landlords.
And the tables turning. That's why they pissed. They see that. Listen. They see us coming. They don't even need to see the whites of our eyes. They see our nappy ass hair. We coming for our shit. Y'all done had it long enough. They done partied and partied and partied. Now the party about over. It's about to be over. I know they gonna try some bullshit. I know they are.
Yep.
But this, you know, we gotta put this party to a fucking close. I'm sick and tired of Goldilocks sleeping in my motherfucking bed and eating my porridge.
That's right. And then being smug about it.
Yeah. When we were at the train station, I believe she was Native American, but she said she just act like she was a white girl. But she was talking so big and bad, and she kept saying, y'all don't look like Indians. Y'all don't look like Indians. But them white Texans behind us were saying, yeah, they Indians. They know who we are. Let me tell you something. The original people that we have the contract with know who the fuck we are. They was handling, can we take your bags? Can we take your bags for you? They was trying to do everything for us because they know we royalty on our land. We got to start being royalty on our land. Every time I deal with a white person who knows the Constitution, they treat us like royalty. But these foreigners, other than them, they want to treat us like trash because they think they're going to get over on us. They're not going to get over on us. No. Nope. No, that shit's over.
Okay.
Right, and what they did, they stopped the blood quantum because they know that was going to stop, put a stop them in their tracks. Mm-hmm. Then they started saying Native because they know they're not American Indian. So they were like trying to build the stack, but what they were doing was they were definitely preparing for their downfall because y'all have nowhere else to turn.
Yeah.
Y'all have nowhere else to turn.
Nowhere. Nowhere except to their handlers, the Democratic Party and the Republican Party. Those are their fucking handlers. But what they gonna do? Because we're getting ready to give them the fucking riot act too. Yeah.
They know if every one of us got tested here, we'll be O blood or O negative or O positive. They know it.
Yes.
I don't care if I'm XYZ, this still my fucking land.
Right.
No, I ain't even letting nobody test me. Fuck you, don't test me for shit. My word, it's there in the UNDRIP. I can classify myself and I'm classifying who I am. I don't need you to take, don't test me. Don't tell me you need to prove who I am. Go ahead, take your time. But in the meantime, redress is due, you son of a bitch.
Yep.
So I don't want to hear, well, you got to prove it to me. Motherfucker, you prove who you are. It's your
word. Prove it to me. That's what I told the court. Well, how do we know who you're Indian? I said, how do I know who you are? Right. You are the imposter. Man. You are my land.
One thing we know for sure is melanated people was on this planet first. Even they said that in their fucking science and their books. Yeah. They might want to change it now. But they know he was first. So it don't matter who I am. I could be the bunny rabbit from fucking space. But if I look like I'm melanated and you don't, I still trump your motherfucking ass.
Yep.
I still trump you.
Facts. Facts.
Really, it don't matter. If you looking and people to tell you, it don't matter. It does matter. I mean, I got a daughter. She got some Irish in her, but I'm her mama. And as long as she come from me, she won us. So her great grandmother is Irish. I didn't know she had to know her father was part white when I married.
No, it's not air. Is that Pomaj's daughter? Mm-hmm. Is not air Pomaj's daughter?
I don't know. She dropped off. She'll be back again.
Oh, who's that talking?
No, this is me talking. This is Chief Sunow, but I see somebody else is here. And I want to know.
I think that's my daughter. I think that's Clan Mother Emi's daughter.
Oh, okay. Well, which one?
This one.
No, that's not my daughter.
That's not her daughter.
Okay. I thought it was your daughter.
That's why I was trying to find out who is Nair. Because she's not saying anything, but I don't see a picture of her to, you know.
Nair, can you say?
Hi. I'm actually Sister Poma's daughter.
Oh, okay. So that's why I was asking. Oh. And how do you pronounce your name, beautiful? Nair?
Nair,
yeah. Nair, okay. And that's your baby?
No, that's actually my older sister. I have a papoose. He is three and a half. Well, I have a papoose. He's 3 and a half.
Okay, well, I'm so happy to meet you. I wish you would have came to New Orleans with us. But next time you'll be there.
Just like a mom.
Yes, I will. My mom told me all about it.
Yeah, we had a great time.
Told me that you guys had an amazing time. She showed me a little bit on like FaceTime. So I was like, oh. But yes. I'm glad that she got to go down there and experience that.
Right. Yes. Now we all got to plan some stuff together and we got to stand now. It's time for
us. Yes, I agree.
It is time. You know, we can. A lot of people want to stay on here. I guess it's if they feel like it's safe to be on YouTube. No, we're not no damn YouTube Indians. That's what they hoping we do. They hoping we stay YouTube Indians. They hope we don't do no further than this. That's why they got that those clowns over there making videos of us over here always talking about us because they want us to keep going back and forth. I can go back and forth with you, nigga, but it's boots on the goddamn ground.
Yeah.
Right.
But you never put no fear in my motherfucking heart. What you need to do is pack up your motherfucking TP, bitch, and goddamn it, get your ass back across that fucking fake ass barrel straight. If that ain't good for you, nigga, that's boats and motherfucking planes, goddamn it. Get your TP and get the motherfucking stepping. You two-stepping thin ice traveling motherfuckers.
Well, you know, it's been proven that they didn't cross the Bering Strait.
I know.
When I saw that document, I took it and kept it, and I'm hiding it. I should frame it and put it in my wallet so the next
you should frame it.
I remember when they debunked it. That's why I called it that fake-ass Bering Strait. Because, you know, they was really riding with that until they debunked it. Now, oh, no, they came by way of a boat. Bitch, we know y'all came by way of a boat. We were going to see how long y'all was going to play this fake-ass Bering Strait. Uh-huh. Bitches was too short to climb a motherfucking ice wall. Let's get that on the motherfucking street.
And then they got a whole story of it. Oh, and, my father's father's father and his mother saw a flower blooming through the ice. I'm like, you know what? How dumb can a motherfucker be to believe that shit? How's a flower go bloom through miles and miles of ice?
Yes.
You know, they really want people to believe that they are mystical and magical and that the world just works for them. Motherfucker, the world don't just work for you. If you don't believe me, your ass is Title 25. Take a look at what title you are. 20 fucking 5.
Good part.
They're not Indians, not taxed. You can't even be Indians, not taxed yet. All of a sudden, some leaves and a flower come up through a mile of ice, and then you pluck it. And then when you pluck it, the ice splits. Oh my God, it's a fucking movie.
So they want us to tell us a motherfucking four leaf clover was their goddamn motherfucking luck, huh? Well, you out of luck now, nigga. You out of luck. Our people, goddamn it, we're back. We ain't never left. We just goddamn it lay dormant because you motherfuckers came here by the boatloads after you had sent our men off to these fake ass wars. And when you came, nigga, you came empty handed. And now you think you better walk away with everything? No, the fuck you ain't. You niggas sitting up in these goddamn houses with our ancestors' antiques and shit. Bitch, how the fuck you got antiques and you broke motherfuckers didn't have shit when you got here?
Didn't have shit when you came.
Now, all of a sudden, now y'all want to claim like y'all, goddamn it, was well off and bathed in your ass. You wasn't doing neither one. Neither one applied to you, motherfucker. Yeah. Y'all was nasty, filthy, lazy, and y'all was going through a goddamn famine. And that's why y'all came here.
And we want all our artifacts and our gold, too.
Yeah,
somebody said they was dragging around their TP and their stuff around America. We had roads and houses and buildings, and we already had cars and stuff like that. We weren't dragging shit around. Y'all didn't come over here with them goddamn TPs. Y'all was TPing it over there in Alaska. What is it with this fucking ribbons everywhere? What is that?
I ain't seen the ribbons.
I did the research on that. You know what those ribbons stand for? Some old witchcraft bullshit that they did
Yes. They always. You know, Nana Woo Woo said something. I believe that's. She said you need to take every fucking cross down. Every cross on the
cross.
Take all that shit down because all that is rituals and witchcraft.
Yes.
The cross is nothing but a man's penis. That's all it is, his balls and his penis. That's what's the two things on the cross. That's all it is a man's penis. And y'all notice everything they talk about is about sex. These motherfuckers ain't got nothing to offer fucking each other. That's it. And they ain't even doing a good job of that. Bitches. That's all they can offer. Everything on TV is sexualized. They have nothing. They are very live, very low vibrational people. We wasn't on that type of level. We was about building fucking nations. We only came together, man and woman only came together to create life. They was not laying up, fantasizing about sex all goddamn day, because if we did, America would have been built up. These motherfuckers ain't built shit over here. Nothing. They haven't built nothing. And a prime example, you can look at the goddamn reservations. If y'all was such great builders, like I keep saying, nigga, no matter where a motherfucker put you at, goddamn, you'll turn that bitch into a kingdom. So how did the motherfucking so-called African-American that y'all claim came by way of a slave ship came and built up America, but they hadn't even built up Africa? Oh, I forgot, because we was already here, nigga. We already did the building. We already had everything that you jealous-ass niggas wanted. That's why you came to America. You said America was beautiful when you got here. We had skyscrapers. We had cobblestone roads. Before you niggas even, before we start paving roads, we had cobblestone roads. I know because they still exist here in Tennessee.
They sure do.
You niggas didn't have nothing. You niggas was dragging around a motherfucking tent on your back. And like you said, they want to act like they so magical and mystical, like they out there in nature. Nigga, you sure is out there in nature because you lazy motherfuckers refuse to clean up the fucking hell hole you live in. How is it they keep y'all such the great people that they claim y'all be, the people that got them and own America, but they leave y'all out there squalor, but tore down all the fucking projects that they put the urban Indians in and rebuilt them for them to live a better life? Even though we don't want to fuck with these motherfuckers, but they still tore them down. How is it the motherfucking so-called slaves that y'all claim that we are living a better motherfucking life? Then y'all niggas.
That's right. Where were they doing all these inventions in this country?
Oh, yeah!
A motherfucking thing. So if you was here, how come you didn't invent a car, a motor, or nothing? Nothing.
That goes the same with us. If we was a slave, like they claim us to be a clan mother. How we goddamn it getting our ass whooped, but in the midst of getting our ass whooped, we building cars and shit. It don't add up, y'all. Think about it. Think about it. How is you inventing everything, but they telling you on the run, getting your ass beat, you're picking cotton, you're doing all these things, but you're doing all these great inventions in between. It don't add up. It don't make sense. There's stupidity at this point. Y'all believe in anything these people tell y'all. And like I said, the only people in our way at this point is niggas that look like us. Niggas that look like us is in our way.
Right, because I really don't have no problem with Caucasoids that you know, I'll talk to and tell them who I am. It's the people that be on YouTube that trying to tell you who you are.
Yep.
Who don't have a life, who's dead.
Yep. We're holding back ourselves because niggas want to run to Africa because they believe if they run to fucking Africa, they're going to get rid of the Caucasian man. They believe that nigga's everywhere. That nigga is everywhere because he's a squatter.
Ms. Axapony asks, how do y'all feel about the Senate hearing?
I've seen that, Ms. Zach. I wouldn't mind. I don't think Top Cat wouldn't say, because I know he'd have played my videos over there when I was cussing out those other people that I used to be with. So let me go over here and find Top Cat's live that he done today. Y'all go on and just press.
Yes, we did, DJ ZPE. Yes, we did. We taught the world. And it's time for us to get to reap the goddamn benefits. If they're asking to come together and it's for, you know, it's not for popularity, that's fine. But to me, it's all about clout for some of these people. And I'm sick of it. I'm sick of it. It's time. Our babies need us. Mm-hmm. This is another 200-year gap that our children have to catch up to.
Yeah.
on their own goddamn land, and I'm sick of it.
Maxine Water. Okay.
To walk that trail of tears together and the need to honor the treaties of 1866. I do not believe that the documented history of the descendants of freedmen can be ignored, forgotten, or dismissed any longer. Thank you, and I'm happy to take any questions that you may have.
Thank you very much, Congresswoman Waters. We appreciate your testimony. Members may submit follow-up questions for the record, and you are excused as we prepare our next panel.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. If the panelists could take their seats as we're introducing them, I'd appreciate it. Our second panel, we have the Honorable Brian Newland, Assistant Secretary for Indian Affairs at the U.S. Department of Interior. The Honorable Chuck Hoskin, Jr., Principal Chief, Cherokee Nation in Oklahoma. The Honorable Louis J. Johnson, Chief of the Seminole Nation of Oklahoma. The Honorable Michael Barrage, General Counsel, Choctaw Nation. The Honorable Jonadev Chowdhury, Ambassador, the Muscogee Creek Nation, Mr. Stephen Greetham, Senior Counsel, the Chickasaw Nation, and Ms. Marilyn Van, President, Descendants of Freedmen of the Five Tribes Association in Oklahoma. I want to remind our witnesses that your full written testimony will be made of the part of the official hearing record, and we would really appreciate it if you could keep your remarks to 5 minutes, because this is an extraordinarily packed panel, and we will start with Secretary Newland. Please proceed with your testimony.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Good afternoon. Thanks to Vice Chair Murkowski.
It's a disgrace.
It's great to be here today. My name is Brian Newland. I have the privilege of serving as Assistant Secretary for Indian Affairs here at the Department of the Interior. I want to thank the committee for the opportunity to present the department's testimony at this important oversight hearing on select provisions of the 1866 Reconstruction Treaties between the United States and the Five Tribes in Oklahoma. Several of these treaty provisions provide certain rights and privileges to some freedmen, who are people who were enslaved and later released from servitude by the Cherokee, Choctaw, Chickasaw, Muscogee Creek, and Seminole Nations.
It's a damn lie.
The Five Tribes. The department appreciates the opportunity to discuss these important treaty provisions. Each of the Five Tribes enacted laws supporting enslavement and/or restricting the rights of enslaved people. In 1866, after the Civil War, each of the Five Tribes entered into treaties with the United States. Those treaties contain provisions addressing the status and rights of freedmen and persons of African descent residing amongst the Five Tribes. It is important to understand that there is no single treaty or uniform law that applies to all freedmen. The Cherokee Nation, the Muscogee Creek Nation, and the Seminole Nation each have their own treaty with the United States, and the Chickasaw and Choctaw Nations share a treaty in common with the United States. All four of these treaties have slightly different provisions relating to the freedmen. In 1896, Congress established a commission to the five civilized tribes to prepare membership rolls for each of the tribes in anticipation of allotting their lands. Congress directed the commission to determine applications for citizenship in each of the five tribes in accordance with their treaties and their laws. Congress also required the commission to make a roll of freedmen entitled to citizenship in said tribes and to include their names in the lists of members. The final rolls would remain with the Commissioner of Indian Affairs and be considered the true and correct rolls of persons entitled to the rights of citizenship in each tribe.
Y'all hear that? I want y'all to listen to what they said, right? Shout out to everybody in the building, man. Appreciate y'all pulling up, man. I'm gonna tell you right now, bro, don't come in this hole without hitting my like button. If you come in this hole, bro, hit the like button. If you come in this hole, hit the like button, bro. So right now, what you're witnessing is, I love it. I do. I'm gonna go ahead on and be honest, bro. I love it. Tell niggas right now, because this right here, if this don't show you that it's real, then nothing will. Every niggas running around here is talking about all this shit about how the ancestors dropped the ball. Niggas running around here talking about what they would do, what they would have done, and how a nigga would have had them fucked up. Niggas talk about all the reclassification, misclassification in the world. Nigga talk about all the ancient building and bridges and every nook and cranny around this hoe. Nigga got all the information, all of the balls. And I'm gonna tell you right now, nigga, you are in the time. At least you get to witness, right? I guess this like a piece of the ass whooping too. You know, kick your ancestors' ass, nigga. And you was talking all that shit about what you would do, and the nigga got you fucked up. Well, they say they finna whoop on your ass too in your lifetime. Finna whoop your ass. You finna get some of this Indian shit too, nigga. You gonna see how it feel to be an Indian, nigga. We finna get down on your ass too, nigga, in your lifetime. And just like your punk ass ancestors, nigga, you ain't gonna do a bitch ass thing about it neither. You ain't gonna do a motherfucking thing. You ain't gonna do nothing. I wanna play this ass whooping. Cause right now we're watching the Senate committee hearing. All right, what are they about to do? They want to reconstruct the 1866 treaty. The only motherfucking thing you niggas got. Only thing you got left, nigga. Only thing they couldn't move. Cherokee in the Nash case. What they do? Drop the freedmen shit. And now they citizens. This the last ride in the sun. They finna whoop up on their ass and everybody. Any way you did have a motherfucking chance, they gonna take it away. Cause niggas don't know how to do nothing but fight each other. And I'm damn near fully convinced that niggas ain't gonna do shit, bro. I am really, really, really convinced. But I ask myself, bro, because there's some great people, bro, that I met on this journey, man. And sometimes I just don't know. You know, we all gonna have our way of how we see this shit and all of that, bro. I'm just gonna stay in my motherfucking lane and my, you know, stay in my lane, bro, because you know, I'm looking at the boy for what it really is, bro. And the reality to me, man, if I can be honest with you, bro. Nigga about to go through the same thing that their ancestors went through, bro. When the real issue came, nigga wasn't ready. Man, I make the analogy, man. It's like when a motherfucker die and they gotta throw a fish fry in the car wash, bury a motherfucker, bro, because they weren't ready. And you know, that's them generational curses that we have to break. and Earth is a school, man, and these lessons are up on you, bro. I'm gonna tell you something. This is real. Listen, bro. I might have to sit this one out, bro, because I don't want no blood on my hands, bro. I'm not gonna be able to take it. I'm a motherfucking winner, bro. I'm going for the win. You know, I can't fuck with no division at this place that I'm in right now, bro. And I don't give a fuck, nigga. I'm a street nigga. I come from a hood background, nigga. I've been gang banging.
Secretary Holland stated that the new constitution, quote, fulfilled the nation's obligations to the Cherokee freedmen and encouraged other tribes to take similar steps to meet their moral and legal obligations to the freedmen. In February, I participated in consultation sessions with leaders of the five tribes to consider the potential for some direct services to the freedmen from the BIA and the BIE. In particular, we asked the tribe's views on whether the Bureau of Indian Education should admit certain freedmen descendants as students at Haskell Indian Nations University and at Southwestern Indian Polytechnic Institute. We continued to review feedback and comments received from that consultation and have not made any decisions on a path forward. Determining eligibility for those services is a challenge for the department when considering the freedmen descendants. The department generally defers to tribes to determine who is and who is not a tribal citizen, as tribes have inherent authority to determine who qualifies as a tribal citizen. And as sovereign parties to treaties, tribes have an important role to play in interpreting those treaties with the United States. However, as Secretary Holland stated last year, the department continues to encourage tribes to take steps to meet their moral and legal obligations to freedmen descendants. The department's grateful to have the five tribes together here today, along with Ms. Van, and we look forward to continuing our work with the five tribes and with the committee as we consider the legal rights and the status of freedmen descendants. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Newland. Chief Hoskin, please proceed with your testimony.
Look at this. Emperor, stop this 1 minute. I gotta say something.
Mr. Chairman,
please.
Members of the committee.
See that woman, Marilyn Van. The only reason why she was accepted and was voted in because she already has admitted that there were descendants of slaves. Listen closely. And that the Native Americans accepted them. That's the only reason why these people accepted her. Look at these people, please. There's no way in the world we're supposed to be asking these people for a goddamn thing. Go ahead, you can put it.
Waddo for inviting me to today. Supreme Court Justice Hugo Black once wrote that great nations like great men should keep their promise. Cherokee Nation is keeping our promise to the Cherokee freedmen and their descendants under our Treaty of 1866. That treaty, Mr. Chairman, is a living, powerful, and foundational document that ties together every one of our agreements with the United States. When we speak of our most important treaty rights, our reservation in Northeast Oklahoma, our right to a delegate in the House of Representatives, for example, we point to the language in the Treaty of 1866, which reaffirms all of our prior treaties, not inconsistent with that treaty. The Cherokees must defend and we must preserve the Treaty of 1866. Article 9 of that treaty states that, quote, all freedmen and their descendants shall have all the rights of Native Cherokees. Not some of the rights, all of the rights. Treaty obligations ought to mean something. Mr. Chairman. You can't pick and choose which parts of the treaty to uphold. We criticize the United States when it fails to live up to its treaty obligations, yet we, as Cherokee Nation, have a responsibility to live up to ours. For Cherokee Nation, the issue of freedmen citizenship was settled 156 years ago. It was settled in a treaty agreed to by the Cherokee people, ratified by this Senate, and signed by the President of the United States. Our ancestors agreed in 1866 to forever cede the right to exclude freedmen and their descendants. This means
damn thing. I want to say something. First and foremost, what's killing me is they're literally having meetings without us there. This is the bullshit we talking about. We're not no freemans. We are the original people of this land.
And like that's the only way they're talking about acceptance. But we don't want y'all fucking acceptance.
Nope.
And when we march down, we don't need y'all with us. Trust that. No, they that's the thing. It's they're excluding us like they've been doing.
And here's the thing though. We don't need them to include us.
That's
we
right.
Include ourselves.
That's right. That's
because
right.
This is our land. We include ourselves in the narrative. And here's the most important thing. They talking about the treaty of 1866. They need to be getting back further to the treaty of 1778, which was the very first treaty, the Delaware Treaty. And the Delaware Treaty outlined everything that we never gave them any fucking land. Period. That's the first treaty. We never gave them no land. And they agreed that this was our land and they were only here temporarily. They ain't gonna ever bring that one up though. I bet you them Native Americans don't bring that one up because it ain't their treaty.
Hold on. Okay, I'm going to try to finish. I'm going to go back and play it, okay, y'all? Y'all
all right.
Play it? Okay.
Were void ab initio, void from the beginning. The enslavement of other human beings and the subsequent denial to them and their descendants of their basic rights is a stain on the Cherokee Nation, and it's a stain that must be lifted. Mr. Chairman, I offer an apology on behalf of the Cherokee Nation for these actions. Just as important,
first of all, that's a corporation. The Cherokee is a corporation.
Right. Facts.
So if y'all niggas thinking y'all a part of that corporation, that is a corporation. That is not a real motherfucking nation here in America. That those motherfuckers are out of Europe and Asia, which is all the same motherfucking place.
I offer a commitment to reconciliation. I'm proud of the many actions that we've taken over the last 5 years towards reconciliation. In 2017, a federal district judge decided the Nash case. That case confirmed that the 1866 treaty remains alive and well and guarantees descendants of Cherokee freedmen shall have, quote, all the rights of native Cherokees. To bring that matter to a close, Cherokee Nation did not appeal. The day after that historic decision, our own Supreme Court affirmed full citizenship for freedmen. We immediately began processing applications for citizenship from freedmen descendants. This day, Mr. Chairman, more than 11,800 applicants have become citizens. In 2021, our Supreme Court
That nigga look like an Italian or something. Somebody help me out on it. Hey, y'all, make sure y'all sharing this video so we can get this out. Very, very important that we get this out.
Jew. That's what he is. He's a Jew.
Hey, don't he look
exactly what he is, Clan Mother Mimi. That's exactly what they are.
Chucky Jr. I don't know. Got his little nigga like Italian or my boss or something, man. What's going on here?
They sure ain't the real ones.
Danny boy, that nigga look like Lucky Luciano, whatever the hell that nigga name was.
Unanimously ruled that the by blood language in our Constitution also violated our obligations.
Shout out to my motherfucking Cutting Junior, goddamn, representing Shock Talk. Hey, that nigga, now Maya Lansky. Well, hey, look, Luciano with a little Maya Lansky in there, huh?
In the Treaty of 1866, our high court determined that those words were invalid from inception and must be removed. As noted, Secretary Holland reviewed our
That nigga like Fredo Coleone riding though.
Constitution later that year, and she wrote the Cherokee Nation had, quote, fulfilled their obligations to the Cherokee freedmen. The Nash decision and our swift actions to implement it was a beginning. It was not an end. We understand that we must embrace the spirit of equality each day. For more than a century prior to the Nash case, freedmen had been disconnected from the Cherokee Nation.
Yeah,
many in the freedmen community did not have the same experiences, the same access to services.
I want y'all to listen because now they're talking about y'all people. They're talking about our people now. For years they weren't included in the community. They didn't feel like they belong. Let's walk.
Same opportunities as non-freedmen citizens. It's essential that we work to bridge that gap. So in 2020, I issued an executive order on equality, reiterating our commitment to that ideal. We also need to make sure that we are mindful of the freedmen experience. So in 2021, I announced the Cherokee Freedmen Art and History Project, which seeks to ensure that freedmen voices are represented within the Cherokee story. I'm proud to appear with my friend Marilyn Van, who I appointed last year to our Environmental Protection Commission, the first Cherokee citizen of freedmen descent to hold a Cherokee Nation appointed government post. Mr. Chairman, I'm here today because it's a
goddamn imperative
that I be here. I'm here to proclaim that having finally kept our promise to Cherokee freedmen, Cherokee Nation is a better nation. It is a stronger nation. Mr. Chairman, I'm here representing a great nation. What do?
Thank you very much, sir.
Ain't that how y'all be saying it? Wado. I bet not ever, you nigga bet not ever tell me Wado no more. I be seeing that because they be having Wado.
Yep, they showed up.
One of y'all said, let me hear how y'all say it. I heard how he said.
I never say that shit because I'm not Cherokee.
Johnson, please proceed with your testimony.
Okay. Hey, Dead Game Boxing say who are the original Cherokee? I'm going to tell you, you want me to tell you some real shit?
The real Cherokee are under your will. These are apostles. We're along with the apostle nation. These motherfuckers are part of the fucking United States Corporation.
That's exactly right, Empress.
Tell you exactly who the fuck they are. And they ain't us.
While we watching this right here, bro,
I'm seriously thinking about writing. What's up, face?
Yeah, I already not caught up.
Seminole Nation, thanks you for this time to be able to speak.
You talking about Maxine Waters?
Yes.
We need to go see her.
We sure should.
We need to go see her. No, we need to make an appointment and the five of us or four of us. We need to go and we need to sit down and talk to her.
I think so. Yes, let's do it.
And we need to tell her what the law is.
A treaty was written.
She's playing a part in this, y'all. Because she know damn well that they ain't the natural people of this land. She's playing a part in this.
Look at him, Empress. Look at this dude here.
Yep.
Selected provisions in the preamble. Whereas existing treaties between the United States and the Seminole Nation are insufficient to meet their mutual necessities, and in view of the urgent necessities for more lands in the Indian Territory, requires a cession by said Seminole Nation
as
part of their present reservation.
It's not too late for us to go and debunk this shit.
No, it's not.
Now is the perfect time. It's the perfect
now is the perfect time
for us to go and stand and say, we don't allow this.
This just happened. This just took place today, y'all. Just took place today.
So that's what I'm saying. We need to go there. We need to go there. We need to get on the phone today, and we need to go there and let them know that they do not have our free, prior, and informed consent to change any fucking treaties. And these motherfuckers keep breaking the law, and we're not doing nothing about it.
That's right. That's
literally sitting here committing fraud. Remember I told y'all what we can get them with, Palmer J. You remember what I told you?
Yes, I remember. What
my cousin Zoe, constructive fraud. We need to get these bitches with this.
As well as deprivation of rights under the color of law, because all laws that they use are colorable law. That has nothing to do with commerce, though.
It had nothing to do with commerce.
You know, although, we can hit them from all sides. Absolutely.
I'm ready, y'all. I'm ready.
I'm ready. I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired.
See, that's why I said we can't wait till October. I mean, we can come together in October, but we need to come together and make a plan now.
Let's meet again and
write this shit out.
Yes, we could. Let's do it.
I'm tired of this stage play. Every time we think we got something, you know,
here they come.
Here they come with another fucking written script for these motherfuckers. All this shit is a stage play to goddamn it, man. Fuck the motherfucking masses who think they're fucking Africans. This is what this is all about. But the motherfucking straight head, fry head motherfuckers, you ain't even got half, nigga. You consider a monster. You ain't fucking natural.
Listen to this. Attempting to cause a person to do something by telling that person that such action is required by law. The shit they're doing is not lawful.
Nope, it's fraud.
It is not required by law. Listen to this. It is not required by law. It is a felony. 18 U.S.C. 242, and I know you know this, Omar, provides that whoever under color of any law, statute, ordinance, regulation, or custom willfully subjects any person, any state, territory, commonwealth, possession, or district to the deprivation of any rights, privileges, or immunities secured or protected by the Constitution or laws of the United States shall be fined under the title or imprisoned not more than 1 year. These motherfuckers are depriving us of our right to be at these fucking meetings.
Absolutely.
18 U.S.C. 245 provided that whoever, whether or not acting under color of law, intimidates or interferes with any person from participating in or enjoying any benefit, service, privilege, program, facility, or activity provided or administered by the United States or applying for or enjoying enjoyment or any prerequisite thereof by any agency of the United States shall be fined under this title or imprisoned, not more than 1 year or both.
It's time for everybody sitting in that goddamn room that they need to be arrested and thrown in jail. Because all of them is under constructive fraud.
Yeah. Oh,
that's right. And all of them responsible for genocide too.
Depriving us of our right to be in any meeting. Those treaties were not written by anybody in there. The people in there have nothing. Nobody in that room has anything to do with a fucking treaty.
None of them. And we ain't signed no motherfucking treaty with this motherfucking corporation.
No, we didn't. 42 USC 1983 provides that every person who under color of any statute, ordinance, regulation, custom, or usage of any state or territory of the District of Columbia subjects or causes to be subjected, any citizen of the United States or other persons within the jurisdiction thereof, to the deprivation of any rights, privileges, or immunities secured by the Constitution and laws, and ours are secured, shall be liable to the party injured in an action of law. And we've been fucking injured big time.
Yes, yes, yes. We've been injured on our land, air, water, everything. Everything has been stripped from us from 1924 Race Integrity.
I'm going to tell y'all right now. I'm telling everyone on this panel. Mm-hmm. I got four people with me that'll go, that's ready to come.
I'm ready to go.
We'll show up at a fucking table.
See, you know, baby, we ain't got no quarrels over here with Chapatula's territory. No.
All we got to do is do it, as far as I'm concerned. Yes. Just like that guy said, who was that talking on here? Who was the Indian that's talking on here, narrating that video?
Oh, that's Top Cat.
Okay. Well, like he said, we just gonna sit around and complain, or we ain't gonna do shit?
I'm through. Like I said, we're not no motherfucking internet Indians. Either you got them in an Indian, and you gonna stand up what's rightfully yours, and quit letting motherfuckers do kick doors on y'all. Niggas are kicking your doors and coming in, sitting in your house, and telling you how to motherfucking act in your own shit. And I don't take lightly to this type of shit.
And the thing is, the law is on our side.
Yes. But we don't know who the fuck we are. Y'all want to keep playing.
I bet you everybody, listen, everybody on this panel know who they are. Fuck the ones that don't know that. How long we going to keep saying, nobody know who they are? I know five people right now who know who they are. And a bunch of people who typing on this know who they are.
Yep.
And I'm going to say this to them, too. All of these people on here talking, OG, Green Machine, Chief the So-and-So, Montari Board, Papatone, all of y'all. Y'all can type and talk, but when we call y'all to the front, are y'all going to come? Or are you just going to come to the YouTube channel and go, yeah, we love you, Copper Empress. Ooh, Copper Empress sure can talk good. Y'all need to get y'all asses up.
Facts. We need the backup now. Hell with that shit. That's why I got off of YouTube. Because of all the goddamn going back and forth, bickering, and our people still in the same predicament.
Thanks.
That's why I got off YouTube. People trying to call people fake and don't even know their genealogy.
Thanks.
Don't even know who they are. But you're attacking people who do know who they are.
There's over a million of them that know who we are, and we can't get 200 people to go to Congress with us. What kind of shitty piece of Indians is that? Ooh, I can't believe you said that, Mimi. Yep, I said y'all some shitty piece of Indians. You know why? Because all y'all can do, y'all, you know what? Thumbs up and like. That's what y'all can do. Thumbs up and like. Shut the fuck up. Y'all talk about, ooh, we ain't Christians. We ain't Jesus. You just like Jesus. You won't show up for shit.
That part. Niggas always running around talking about they Indian, so I'm not my motherfucking ancestor. You goddamn right. Because the ancestors fought till they couldn't fight no goddamn more. And that's a fact. So no, niggas ain't like they motherfucking ancestors. They goddamn laying down and taking it.
Yep.
It's over, baby, because Goddess, we're going to get on the phone tomorrow and make that appointment.
Yes, we are.
Y'all want to finish this and summon more of this? Or
y'all and I want these people that's on here to start thinking about coming with us. That's what I'm saying. We need y'all. We need y'all to do more than like and thumbs up and give $5 and $10 here and there on the Cash App. That's cool, too. But God damn it, y'all need to show the fuck up. You do. Because it's not, you can't just, one thing I can say about Martin Luther King and all them who was fighting for civil rights, he sure had a lot of people show the fuck up. Now we got some, the real people, and y'all won't show the fuck up, you lazy fox.
First of all, he had a million people to show up for the wrong motherfucking thing. This is the right motherfucking thing.
That's so how many
of us gonna goddamn it show up to goddamn it let these motherfuckers know that we've been here, we ain't never left here, and all the fuck shit that y'all done to us, we want our shit, and we ain't asking no goddamn more.
See, now they saying they gonna show up, so this is what we gonna do. When we get the date, this is what we need to do. We need to get a number for y'all to call. For y'all to call. And if you're really serious, call the number. And when we get the date, we're going to have our million Indian march.
There you go. And no, we're not going to march. We're going to go sit in Congress on the ass.
Yeah. You know what? That's what I'm talking about.
I'm ready to say, you know, Indigenous People Day is coming.
That's October. That's October 28th, where they're marching in New York.
Yeah.
And they're talking about all Indigenous people from around the world. I think our copper-colored Indigenous people need to stand the fuck up right now.
We need to be at the, not the White House. We need to be right there at the goddamn door.
This is an emergency.
Yep.
State of emergency.
Yep. We need to start showing up and showing out. Besides shooting each other and doing all other kind of shit. No, you know, showing somebody's big ass. And,
oh, we're not going to march, y'all. We're not going to the house. We're not marching.
Pimping and all that other shit and how much you can smoke and how much this. Instead of doing that, take some of them little ducats of yours and get your ass either on a bus or start walking now. If you can't drive, start walking now. Shit.
American King shut down every goddamn city. Because y'all wouldn't make no money if it wasn't for us. Sick of it. I'm tired. Y'all there, my sisters?
Yeah. Yup.
Hold on. Here I come. Yeah, I'm here.
And Matriarch said, we board this train or get the fuck out the way.
Providing new and adequate land for them. The first phrase of the preamble is the opening words of the 1866 treaty. The existing treaty reference is the 1856 treaty, which was in fact sufficient for the Seminole, for it consisted of millions of acres of land and provided in the language of that specific treaty that the desires of the United States were the determining factor for the Seminole being the only tribal nation of the Reconstruction Treaty era forced to cede every inch of their land. 2,169,080 acres was ceded at 15 cents an acre. The Seminole understood the 2,169,080 acres ceded was to be assigned to other Indians and freedmen to live their own. This promise was neither fulfilled nor honored. This language is present in Article 3 of the 1866 Treaty. And is the first time in the treaty where the term freedmen is mentioned. As stated in the preamble, a need for ceded land was for only a part, not the whole of the Seminole original initial reservation. It is a reasonable price was never paid for the ceded land during this era, 15 cents an acre, nor was adequate sufficient land provided as understood by the Seminole. The first sentence of Article 3 reflected the intent of the United States as the Seminole understood it to mean. The 1866 treaty ultimately was not honored in totality by the United States because the intent of Article 3 was not adhered to. There are documents from all three branches of the United States government addressing this specific section of land. That fulfills my time at this time.
I'm splitting my time with Assistant Chief Palmer.
His ass sitting up there with a smirk because he know this ain't the real fucking people.
Assistant Chief Palmer, please proceed.
Thank you.
This is supposed to be an indigenous person, too.
I had
a question. Can you put
that
on pause? I had a question.
Sabaklet, Mongeese. During opening remarks, Nahaza reauthorization 1 year ago on this date, the following was stated. The United States.
Okay, here's my question. If we, what they doing against the law? I'm asking this question seriously.
You're damn right.
It is okay. Against the law.
It is against the law.
Poma, is this against the law? Is she still there?
Yes, she's there.
Yes, ma'am. I was tending to the baby. I had to change her. She was fussy, crying up a storm. I missed it.
Can you tell me if what they're doing right now is against the law, Poma?
Oh, absolutely.
Can you tell me how it's against the law?
Well, initially, Article 1, Section 2, Clause 3. They're not speaking about the aborigines of this country are so-called Indians, or you can say it in reverse, so-called Indians are the aborigines of this country. Because they know that going furthest back, we didn't call ourselves Indians. And we're the only one attached to that history. There are people on the top
right there. Stop right there. Stop right there.
Uh-huh.
Why aren't we start? First thing we need to do is what you just said. Let's start off with that in a letter.
Absolutely.
You see where I'm going with this?
At the beginning.
You see where I'm going with this?
Yeah.
And then once we get through with that show, talk about all the fucking laws they done broke.
Yep. That's
we need to send it to every last one of them.
That's easy to do. You know that's
easy what we need to do. And we need to, if nothing else, get on Zoom and start there.
Absolutely.
Start with the fucking letter. I know one thing. If don't nobody else start with the letter, I'm gonna start with the fucking letter.
I'll be there.
It's hard as we think it is because we got the fucking law. That's the law. Start with that.
Yes.
Start with that.
And if y'all really love your babies, and
nobody in that meeting was indigenous or
not at all. Nobody but whatever damn name is the very first one we seen, but her ass is a fucking sellout. Because she know damn well ain't none of these people indigenous. Maxine Waters, whatever her goddamn name is.
What's the
Marilyn Van? Marilyn Van already said she African.
Yo.
And that totally gave them people the narrative to do what they do.
That's right, American King. That's exactly where we going. We going to demand a congressional hearing. Yes. My thing is, once we demand it, we going to start with this fucking letter.
Yes.
Once we demand it, all of y'all clicking likes and shit, y'all asses better show up. Because if I see you on YouTube and you don't show up and y'all go, yeah, thumbs up, we on fire. Woo, listen to them talk. You know what I'm doing? I'm going to have to cut all y'all motherfuckers off because you ain't shit. I want it. You can't just depend on us to do what you got to do it with us. It's your land too.
Yes, you claim you love your babies. You want to save these babies from going through this fuck shit they're getting ready to do to us again. Then stand up for your own bloodline. We got to stand up for our own bloodline.
That's right.
And it's up to you to stand up for your bloodline.
What? So now when we get off of this Zoom, we already got a group text. Let's pick a day to get on Zoom and write this letter. Let's go all the way. Because I'm telling you, if I start walking, you get me to start walking, I'm going to keep right on walking. I'm going to keep right on walking. Then I got some people in my nation state that's going to walk with me.
And
I know I got some in y'all's nation state that's going to walk with you.
No, my king just said, come on. My king just said, look, come on.
Listen, let me tell you something.
Said, a case against, we need to go against not only just United States Corporation, but we need to hold these motherfucking natives reliable for stealing our motherfucking nationality and running around here perpetrate. They're committing fraud by making like identity fraud, by making like they're us. Period. Period. We getting both of these motherfuckers.
I'm gonna tell you why, and I thought about this because I wanted to sue them for identity fraud, but they're not trying to steal our identity. They're trying to replace it.
Well, there you go.
Well, here's what I'm saying. Lawfully, we would lose. You know why? Because they're having our identity removed. So they're not trying to.
That's what they're doing. That's your right. But they're trying to have our identity removed.
Yes.
Claiming our history as if it was them.
Yeah. And that's genocide right there.
Yes. Genocide. We charge genocide.
Yes. Exactly. Racial classification yet again. And we're not going, you're not finna reclassify us no more. Better yet, y'all can make y'all way to the motherfucking boardwalk. Down there, get your ass back on these motherfucking Ellis Island, Angel Island, which one you motherfuckers near, get your ass back and get back to where you at. Because we tired. We tired at this point. I'm finished playing a little bit more Clan Mother Mimi.
Okay, thank you for letting me speak. Thank you.
You're welcome.
States signed more than 370 treaties, passed laws, and instituted policies that have come to define the special government-to-government relationship between the federal and tribal governments and obligates the federal government to promote the general well-being of Native American tribes, yet the United States has failed to provide that assistance. Any treaty must be viewed through the author's eyes and those who reluctantly agreed to it. Weighted consideration must be given to the government's chosen language, intent, and the atmosphere in which it was constructed 156 years ago. This is how the U.S. Constitution is viewed. This is how the treaties are viewed. Article 2 of the Seminole Nation Treaty of 1866 reads, in part, many persons of African descent and blood who have no interest or property in the soil and no recognized civil rights shall be permitted to settle, have and enjoy the rights of all Native citizens, equally binding laws, and may be adopted as citizens or members. The Dawes Commission.
Stop it. Okay, he's the assistant chief speaking right now, the Honorable Brian Thomas Palmer, assistant chief Seminole Nation of Oklahoma. Redhead, Bush is not. What Kyle is? Kyle in here. Kyle, it's them redheads you was talking about. Somebody say Canelo Alvarez.
And certainly categorize Freedmen and Seminoles separately and introduce blood quantum. Phrases and terms utilized within the treaty are not the words of the Seminole. They're the words and desires of the federal government. This short testimony to discuss select provisions is a disservice to the Seminole and warrants a deeper conversation. Grossly negligent oversights of the treaty agreements still occur beyond the McGirt case. The government must account for and consider the impact any decision may have on a financially fragile tribal system that has yet to overcome historical poverty caused by previous lack of protection defined by the treaties in times of war and hostility, loss of valuable oil and land, and continual suffering from the historical trauma caused by the Indian Removal Act. As an elected official under the oath of office of the Seminole Nation, I must uphold the treaty, the tribal and U.S. Constitution, the tribal codes as they are written.
What treaty?
Govern the Seminole. But oh.
Thank you very much. Mr. Burridge, please proceed with your testimony. Am I pronouncing your name correctly?
Burridge.
Yes,
Senator. Thank you and good afternoon, Chairman Shodds, Vice Chairman Murkowski, Senator Langford, and Senator Smith. My name is.
What'd you say, Chief Sonnell?
I said, look at this man. Ain't slept in a block with a fucking Indian.
Can you, y'all can't make this shit up no more.
What did you say?
Look at this shit.
I am so pissed, y'all. Y'all just don't know. I am so pissed.
What did you say about this guy?
I said, look at him. He ain't slept in a block with a goddamn American Indian.
Oh. Yeah.
Where this motherfucker at? I just seen in the chat said, none of y'all niggas will lay a white hand on a white man. God, I don't give a fuck about the white man or the goddamn African. How about that, motherfucker? The Africans don't give a fuck about us, so this ain't about you or the motherfucker. It's about our motherfucking land and our motherfucking rights as the indigenous motherfucking people. Bitch, kick rocks with flip flops.
Africans don't give a fuck about Africans. Why he over here talking shit about us?
Yeah, exactly. That's why they running in.
Them Chinese that's over there fucking your mama, man. That's what you need to do.
Carrying them motherfuckers on your back and shit. The fuck on out of here. And what was y'all saying, Cheese Son Al? Y'all want me to explain? Okay, let me go.
Oh, no, continue, goddess. Okay. Continue. I apologize.
This is Michael Burridge. I'm general counsel for and a member of the Choctaw Nation of Oklahoma. I'm here at the request of and on behalf of the chief of the Choctaw Nation, the Honorable Gary Batten, who the committee invited to testify.
You hear that, chief?
I sure the fuck do. These are the people we need to sue, y'all. Right here. These fake imposters.
Yep. Right here.
Testify on a matter of grave importance to the integrity of the Choctaw Nation. I began representing the Choctaw Nation in 1974 upon graduation from the University of Oklahoma College of Law. At that time, I moved to Anders and began my law practice. I have represented the Choctaw Nation ever since that time in 1974, except for an approximate seven-year period when I was appointed by President Clinton to be a United States District Judge, being chief judge for five of those years and also serving on the 10th Circuit Court of Appeals by designation. I was told that I am the first Native American to be appointed to the federal bench. I want to make one thing very
clear. Make this understood. He is a Native American because Native American only means born here. So when he called himself a Native American, he's motherfucking right. He ain't a motherfucking American Indian, that's for sure.
Well, that's what makes the fraud even better.
Yep.
Because they know what the, see, here's the thing. Here's where the fraud is. You're claiming to change a treaty that belongs, that doesn't belong to Native Americans, but belongs to Indians in the United States of America.
I'm sick of these folks. Yeah, I mean, this is really, really, really.
So they keep saying, they keep telling us that they're cheating and lying. They right there saying.
Yeah, they saying that this we're going to hold this against these bitches. This motherfucking lying that they're doing, we're going to hold this. You're going to be held accountable, nigga, because you are a constructive fraud.
Where in the fuck does any of these treaties say Native anything?
They don't. They don't. Native was just coined back in 1975, nigga.
When the Constitution constantly said Article 1, Section 2, Clause 3, Indian, and even in Title 25, it can said American Indian until, 1980? Then it started using Native American. How all of a sudden did an American Indian become a Native American? Who did that shit? And you can't blame that on Plecker.
No, you can't. He was just one of the hands in the motherfucking pot. That's all. That's it.
Clear. And please listen. The Freedmen issue as it relates to the Choctaw Nation has nothing to do with race. I repeat, has nothing to do with race. Tribal membership is based on blood, not race. Today, the Choctaw Nation tribal members includes African Americans as well as those from other races.
Yeah, under Title 25 means under y'all jurisdiction. Fuck that.
You can't include African Americans in any of these fucking treaties.
Because they have no nationality. Have no nationality.
Facts. And that's why I keep trying to tell people there's no such thing as an African fucking American. How the fuck are you older than your motherfucking nationality? That's bullshit. You are born into your nationality.
You don't just become something. The fuck wrong with these goddamn people?
All members of our tribe share one characteristic in common. They are Choctaw by blood, and they're all lineal descendants of Choctaw Indians.
Now one of these motherfuckers are Choctaw by blood. None of them.
Right, none of them are.
I'm so sick of these fuckers.
The Constitution of the Choctaw Nation was established by a United States District Court order dating May 9th, 1983, in an action entitled Morris versus Watt. With federal approval by the government on June 9th, 1983, I repeat, with federal approval by the federal government on June 9th, 1983, ratified by a vote of the tribal members, certified by the Choctaw Election Commission on July 25th, 1983, this constitution, approved by the federal government, limits membership to Choctaws by blood and their lineal descendants. Chief Batten and I, as general counsel, take an oath to uphold and defend this constitution. Our constitution has existed and worked well for almost four decades, but now another part of the federal government that approved that constitution wants to unilaterally walk it back without the consent of the Indians affected and without consent of the tribe. Does that sound familiar to you when it comes to the federal government's treatment of Indians and Indian tribes? In the Choctaw Nation's recent litigation against the federal government over the unallotted lands, United States District Judge Lee R. West, who I served with and was appearing as counsel for the nation at that time, said the federal government has made many agreements with the tribes and did not keep them. He said that was not going to happen in his courtroom, and it did not. It is the federal government, by placing tribal membership in a political arena, that initiated this freedman issue, not the Choctaw Nation. If there's a problem, the federal government needs to find another solution that does not infringe upon the rights of the Choctaw people or the integrity of our self-governance. In 1978, in Santa Clara Pueblo versus Martin S., the Supreme Court held a tribe because of its sovereignty and principles of self-determination has the exclusive authority to determine its membership. Following this, the 10th Circuit Court of Appeals in Ordinance 59 Association versus U.S. Department of Interior Secretary held, I quote, tribes, not the federal government, retain authority to determine tribal membership. This holding should be honored by all branches of the federal government. The lawful interpretation of treaties, case law, and history that relates to Indians is complicated. There are special rules of construction when it comes to treaties with the tribes. We are here today having been drawn into a political process where decisions can have far-reaching legal consequences. I respectfully ask this committee, it is a congressional hearing where time is limited and personal and political concerns are on the table, the proper place to adjudicate such an important matter as tribal membership. Then you add on top of that, legislative threats are made. If the tribe does not make the decision wanted by some politician, critical housing funds for tribal members that need the housing may be withheld. How can this be squared with the United States government's trust duties and obligations to the tribes? How is this anything that undermining the tribal self-determination and tribal autonomy? After surviving the cruelty of the Trail of Tears, the Dawes Act, the near termination of our tribal functions, nearly two centuries of taking at the hand of the United States government, the Choctaw Nation and these other tribes deserve better. This all goes to the...
I have something to say. Where was these motherfuckers at when all this, the wars and shit was going on? When all these wars, Indians against Indians, where was they at? These motherfuckers bleeding, painting the goddamn picture and shit. Where was these motherfuckers at? Now, I've been showing y'all videos of Oklahoma and other towns around, other major cities around in America. And we ain't seen none of these motherfuckers. So where were they at, Tonto? Just sitting here listening to these motherfuckers lie. Oh, this is sickening.
Core of the constitutional identity of the sovereign tribe that is threatened.
I had a lying motherfucker.
Thank you for your attention to this matter. And when appropriate, I'll be glad to answer any questions about what I have said or other questions, especially about the Morris case. I was there.
Hey, Mike say, y'all heard him, Shoctown Mike. Shoctown Mike say, and I'm here to take all fades. If there's anybody out here want to take a fade with Shoctown Mike, because I was there. Yeah. He said he was there. Taking out fans, I'm gonna put the mic down, but my shoes are tied.
I represented the tribe, although at that point in the game, I was carrying briefcases more than
the motherfucker said. Yeah,
they sound like they on the Letting Their Top Cat podcast, huh? What do you say? They're part of the game. These niggas out there looking at the board. Yeah, man, y'all, watch out. And see, in the Pan Africans and all these other ideologies, you even have some people coming out of the black ideology. You know, they always sit up there looking at, because they really don't, they don't even know what a Native American really look like.
Besides they don't. The
pictures. They don't know the reality. They don't know the white boy on side of them is the Native American. They have no clue. I really appreciate this video today. I appreciate Shoctown Mike just being himself. You know, a white boy. And he's looking at the board. What he say, you know, at that part of the game, you know, back then, you know.
It's all about the gaining of our land and pushing us in another territory. You niggas ain't going to motherfucking Oklahoma this time. They try to push your ass across the pond.
They want you. That's right. And they're trying to get out. Now here they're trying to say that the freedman is old. They're trying to get out of that.
Yes.
Listen what they're saying.
And have the nurses say the honorable. Ain't nothing honorable about this shit. The motherfuckers literally sitting here lying. Sick ass shit.
Back in the game, you know, fucking the hoes, not the cocaine, carry me. Now, I ain't say that, but I'm just bullshitting. But what I do want to appreciate him for is showing motherfuckers that these are real people. About these real people.
Nothing real about these motherfuckers. This is
what they look like now. Now, they look like a Shoctown Grady, but this is the reality of what's going on here. And they're here to argue. They want another shot at the 1866 treaty. Right? Because they need that land back.
Look at these motherfuckers, y'all. These motherfuckers are the Caucasians that are claiming to be motherfucking natives. They're literally Europeans. All of them are the offspring, even the so-called natives are the offsprings of the Europeans. All this goes hand in hand to take the land. And what makes me mad was these motherfuckers jumping that goddamn chat. They claim to be so motherfucking African, a pan-African. Nigga, they taking your land. And what the fuck you gonna do, bitch?
All them land patents and all that.
Nigga, sad and with bullshit.
They need
weak ass niggas. Block that bullshit.
They need a do over. You know, since niggas ain't there to speak for themselves. 1866 treaty.
Then it's sitting box in my goddamn chat because we got him on their ass.
Quote unquote to black niggas. So, why ain't no black niggas there? Where the niggas at? Why we sitting in this room talking about niggas and ain't no niggas in this house? But Mike, shout out Mike, stand up and say, I was there. Well, what are the other niggas at that was there too? That was a long time figure out. What are niggas at?
Yeah.
How we in here? The whole conversation is about the niggas. You hear every time they read and write, that's why everybody went through. You heard the Cherokee. They just got through, who was that, Chucky? Chucky just got through talking about Nash, Cherokee versus Nash, and niggas was getting done bad, and now they cool, they in there, they, you know. That's why he's talking about niggas, but ain't no niggas in this house. That's why.
Lawyering, but I know what was discussed at those hearings. And
I heard about it. This ain't no.
Look at this nigga face, though.
Come on, bro, where the people at?
Is he lying? Just look, look at his face.
At? I'll tell you where he is. Some of them out here lost in the South. fell under some type of doctrine. Some of them Aboriginal. Some of them claim it is Indian shit. Which is this, that shit there, that Indian and that Aboriginal shit, that shit they want to get fucked out. Since that shit they got niggas fucked out, we might well kick, because we really ain't that one of them motherfuckers. Them motherfuckers from Terms. These niggas ain't out here. Notice they ain't. Look, look, this the big boy shit. Nigga, this the Senate committee hearing. You heard, have you heard anybody talk, say any motherfucking thing about an Indian or Aboriginal? He's from the Choctaw Nation, not the.
Thank you very much. Ambassador Chowdhury, please proceed with your testimony.
You need a goddamn head, man. You need a bomb. Brady the mouse type of shit. Gotta figure
this
shit out, bro.
Mado, I've got a long history with these buttons. Do I have?
Wado. Y'all nigga, I'm telling you, bro.
Did I go back?
I don't want nigga, I'm telling you, Wado. Wado, no more. What I'm gonna say is, look, this is the big boy shit. Nigga, this is the city of me here. You heard? Have you heard anybody talk, say any motherfucking thing about an Indian or Aboriginal? He's from the Choctaw Nation, not the Indian Nation, not the Choctaw Indian. He's from the Choctaw Nation, nigga. You know what it is off of that. And I'm going to fall under my Indian, nigga.
Well, they got them bots coming in here like a motherfucker now.
But we sitting here banging it out, nigga, like this the end all be all. Nah, that's a step on your journey to where you going, nigga. And right now, they about to cut your water off.
They ain't cutting shit off, because we about
niggas
to.
Don't figure this
yeah,
shit
we about
out.
To do some motherfucking head cutting our goddamn sales.
We about to do some red sticking around this bitch.
Hell yeah.
I'm telling you, bro. Don't tell me no more.
This is a Russian name. I don't care what nobody says.
He was the name I looked up earlier. I was trying to find him. I couldn't find him nowhere.
My game, bro.
I'm looking to see if that's Russian.
I don't know, bro. Fuck all this shit. A lot of shit, you know. I don't give a fuck about a lot of this shit. I ain't got no motherfucking bow and arrow. Nah, man, I ain't got no motherfucking bow and arrow over here, nigga. I got motherfucking chopsticks. Yeah. Nah, nigga, I'm a different kind, bro. I ain't. Listen, man. We got the whole doctrines. You know,
it's Asian. Keeping us it's an Asian last Asian name, y'all.
Fight, bro. I don't want. Listen, man. I'm through with the spirit.
It says predominantly in Asian.
All of that type of shit right there. You know, I ain't on none of that type of whole ass shit. Then. What I'm gonna say is,
you hear me, Chief?
This is
what you said, my baby.
It's an Asian last right name.
That sure is, or Russian.
It's 1866,
which we know all that's the same word.
The Cherokee got in there. What were they saying, bro? You know what? Them people got the
Cherokee. It says money from the government. Surname is derived from Middle High German word.
U.S. government. We just
meaning new. Man, mean man, such as the name is most like a recent nickname.
Into these plays, bro. And what they're doing is they're exiting.
We gotta realize the Jews is German. That's where they came from.
Yes. It says the surname is derivative from the Middle High German words. Nui meaning new and man meaning man, such as the name, and was most likely originally a nickname for some who had recently moved to this location. Get the fuck out of here. Yes, it did.
And I'm finna pull this up, y'all. I'm finna scream.
Yes, yes.
These motherfuckers is fucking with, like we said, crisis actors, y'all.
I'm tired of them playing with us. It's time. It's time, y'all. Y'all be sitting in these chats. Let's see how y'all ready to roll. Let's see.
Get the fuck out of here. It's in the fucking name and that. Okay, y'all. Hold on, y'all. Let me go over here. That clown. Can y'all see it?
No.
Hold on. Hold on. Share. Stop. We can always go back to that. It's gotta be that one. Yes. Y'all see it? Can y'all see it?
No.
Yes, Goddess, we can see it.
Okay. Hold on, let me come back over here to Facebook on my phone. I want y'all to see it for yourself. It's the bullshit, y'all. I hope it's not big enough for y'all. Let me see if I can. God damn, I keep forgetting when we be sending this shit over here. You can only. How can we make it where it can? What a lyric I had.
Just I talk home you. Talking about she going to get in the tub because she freezes as soon as she walk in here. It's cold.
Oh, Lord. It says, where did this last name come from? It says the Neumann surname is derivative from the Middle High German word Neue, meaning new, and man, meaning man, as such as the name was most likely originated a nickname for someone who had recently moved to this location.
Telling you right there.
Don't get no, I ain't got time. You can't make this shit up, Empress. You can't make this shit up, y'all. Let's go back over here. Wait a minute. So we can finish out with these motherfucking clowns. All y'all have to do who want to see it, just put in. I put in, was it a Russian name? But it gave me Asian. But now, but when you start opening up those links, it says that Russia, that part. So let me stop sharing this and go back to sharing the screen I was sharing. Okay, y'all.
Especially you ain't free, Miss Daddy. You ain't a motherfucking thing, nigga. And so, right now, they just
don't do Palmer, away, y'all.
Should have gone X niggas out, Cherokee, mad. In
the her grandbaby was really crying.
Okay, okay.
Nigga should have just held out, nigga. God damn. Because right now, nigga, let me tell you something. If they're able to do this, brother, because Oklahoma, Indian territory, that's nigga territory. If you know the history of it, even when they flooded that bitch and built these towns and shit, even when the Southeast Indians did come over, you still had different tribes in there, man. Osage and all of these different tribes in that area. Melanated people, niggas too. They fought like a motherfucker. But then, you know, a lot of them became family.
They was the same people.
And when in that treaty, you have to understand they won Oklahoma for them. They won that motherfucker, bro.
They was the same people, y'all. You know the Muskogee, Chickasaw.
The wars that took place there, man.
Creek, which is derived from Muskogee.
And out of that area, bro. A lot of our people got history in there, bro. This shit here is going to affect a lot of motherfuckers. Nigga ain't just write a piece of paper and say, hey, I'm going to give you something because you ain't got nothing now. They won Oklahoma. Civil War, what we talking about? So after the Civil War, because these niggas fighting on the United States Colored Troops. So since they fought for the Union, the U.S., all right, when they sit down at the treaty.
We need to look up the rest of those names to get up there, y'all.
They pulled out. Now they're coming back in to the U.S.
Do that genealogy on there.
You know, yes. Basically, I just shot it out with you. But shit, they was even able to come back to the table and work together. So what I'm saying, niggas had a whole civil war and they found some type of way to goddamn, you know, keep you niggas at the bottom together. But that's why, you know, they really was like rewarded like that. And so Oklahoma is really niggas territory under this treaty. Niggas really got their own world out there. Niggas be talking about, oh, just give us a piece of land and let us just be. Well, you really got action in it.
That shit over.
Create a motherfucking action where you can get the minds to sit down. And, you know, maybe you put your most brilliant minds together, maybe y'all can figure something out. Or maybe it's true, niggas just can't come together.
Got it right, sir. You got it right.
You're doing great. Thank
you. Next year, John Dove, Sula, Chaudhry, Jezef Kados, Azadun Masi, Ibufunga, Amalga, Bukmitas. Mr. Chairman, Vice Chair, members of this esteemed committee, thank you for the opportunity to testify. My name is John Dove, Sula Chaudhry, and I'm proud to serve as ambassador of the Muskogee Creek Nation. As I sit here before you today, the sovereignty
next
of all tribal nations what is under say? Attack.
That's a fucking Mexican.
Mm-hmm. He does look like a Mexican, don't he? Well, not even that. He's not a Mexican because we know the real Mexicans are us. This nigga is a Chino, which is Asian.
Ago, the German. Supreme Court upheld our nation's sovereignty in McGirt versus Oklahoma. Just this past month, however, the court chose to abdicate it in order to placate Oklahoma politicians. Congress has a duty to protect the sovereignty of all tribal nations. That duty is all the more pressing when one branch of the federal government seeks to eliminate it.
Listen, bro, you hear how these niggas talking? Now, listen to me, family. Do y'all hear the words coming out of his mouth? Congress, nigga, you got a motherfucking obligation, nigga, to uphold this shit, nigga. This the place that you niggas belong in. You got your, under this treaty, nigga, he can only talk like that. This the only treaty. Check. This sovereignty shit he talking about, this is this way he got it. Right now, they are fighting for you to be able to step up, nigga, and keep. Right now, you have me. You just ain't using it. That's who you. Now watch this up, now. Creek don't let niggas in a citizens, right? Creek ain't letting you in, they say. It's another reason they got a big boy why we here today. They want to get their bitch gone. They split it up. You got 140 acres apiece. Everything that these niggas got, they gave it to you, especially with the creek. Them niggas ain't got no, they can't big Indian nobody around this hoe. And they got their ass whooped. I'm saying, and they got their motherfucking ass whooped.
They trying to say, okay.
And we whooped it.
I pulled up that other fat ass nigga just up at the Burgridge. He, it says ancient Anglo-Saxon, culture of European. I pulled up his coat of arms saying Europe, coming out of Europe, England, coming out of England. Really, nigga? Okay.
And then they had to come to the table and they gave him head. They said, fuck, ooh, that's some hoe ass shit. So just by you knowing why they gave him head, that meant they really was supposed to get a new lesson. That really mean you really had more motherfucking control over than anything, because everybody didn't get half. Everybody ain't get half, homie. The critics had too, and just by them giving them half, that you know you had more rights to the shit than they did. You really had fucking control over than anything, because everybody
roots to injustices against both Native Americans and African Americans. It goes without saying that slavery is and always has been wrong. And just as the United States fought a civil war over slavery, the Creek Nation fought its own civil war. On one side were the traditionalist Upper Creeks, who opposed the imposition of colonial American life into our nation, including the legalization of slavery. I'm a descendant of Fishpond and other Upper Creek towns.
Listen to this
shit.
My
mom used to explain family oral history, stating that when our family and other Creeks would raid slave owners, we would give freed slaves three options. One, receive our assistance for passage to the north. Two, live among us and with us. Or three, join an autonomous.
Y'all hear this, y'all?
If they was living with
you. Yes, ma'am.
Here's the thing. If they was living with you and among you, then why they have to fight to live with you and among your ass now?
That part right there.
This black community within the larger Muskogee world. However, these practices conflicted directly with the goals and desires of the most prominent lower Creeks, who sought to fully assimilate every aspect of white American culture into the fabric of our nation, including slavery, cotton, and Christianity. Instead of allowing the conflict of Creek Nation to play out through our own internal democratic processes, the United States intervened and dispatched General Andrew Jackson to exterminate the Upper Creeks. The United States' goal was nothing less than complete annihilation. In 8 months of massacres, the United States burned nearly every Upper Creek home and murdered thousands of men, women, and children. My ancestors from Fishpond sought refuge at Horseshoe Bend, the Tallapoosa River in Alabama, and they were slaughtered by Jackson and the slave-owning Cherokee leaders, John Ross and Major Ridge, who volunteered to fight with them. At Tallahatchie, Jackson locked 50 men, women, and children in a cabin and burned them alive. Horseshoe Bend and the scores of massacres that preceded it silenced the strong anti-slavery faction within the Creek Nation. Jackson's extermination policies against the Upper Creeks created Alabama and resulted in the Indian Removal Act and ultimately the Trail of Tears. Even so, thousands of Creeks fought on the side of the Union in the American Civil War. Once again, we were targeted, our homes burned, and hundreds died. In exchange for our loyalty, the United States promised that once the war ended, our nation would not lose any land, and all the loyal Creeks would be financially assisted. Both promises turned out to be lies. The Treaty of 1866 has often been characterized as a Reconstruction Treaty. For us, it was not. It was a land grab that stripped us of half out of our reservation by force. And my great-great-grandpa up Knee Hill, who fought for the Union, said the final payment from the United States wasn't enough to buy a hat. It is important to note that we are not Cherokee Nation. We are not Chickasaw Nation. We are the Muskogee Creek Nation. Our treaty with the United States contains different language than the treaties of other tribal nations. Our current constitution was reviewed and approved by the Department of the Interior. However, the interpretation of this treaty is currently the subject of ongoing litigation. Any true solution must go beyond the shallow political rhetoric and the yes-no binaries that such rhetoric supports. To that end, we've begun a process at Muscogee Creek Nation of developing historical, cultural, and legal research that will help our citizens engage in a thoughtful and
one thing he said that they created Alabama. It was not even called Alabama, y'all. It was called Alamo. I got a old map. It was called Alabama. Bitch, quit lying. Sitting up here just doing all this goddamn lying.
Informed exploration this issue as they exercise sovereign right to determine the future of the Muscogee Creek Nation. The Muscogee Creek Nation is proud of our diverse citizenship. We have citizens who have mixed ancestry. We're also white, African-American, Mexican-American, and many other heritages. I myself.
Hey, fam, let's hit the lights up. Let's hit the lights up so we can get some more people in here. Let's hit the lights up so we can get in the algorithm and get some more people in here. It's a very, very important. You know what I'm saying? We need people to hear this shit. You feel me? Right now, we listen to Jonah Doe. We're going to call him John, okay? Jono. And he out the Muscogee Creek Nation. He's an ambassador.
Creek.
See, niggas send ambassadors out here, bro. His homeboy probably ain't get along with one of them niggas up there.
This nigga's an ambassador at the motherfucking United Nations, y'all. Why do they got an ambassador and you don't?
Bro, we gotta change that mindset. Man, this shit can get real crazy. Italian.
And Asian. But whatever else we may be, we are all Creek Indians by blood. And as a nation that has endured policies intended to exterminate us because we're Creek Indians by blood, citizenship and
non-Creek
persons engender deep conflicting emotions. Quite frankly, our citizens stand on both sides of these issues. We're working towards healing. We're not only the descendants of select families that own slaves, but also those who opposed slavery and incurred the targeted and murderous wrath of the United States military. But the solution to this is not another colonial intervention by the United States. Mado.
Thank you very much for your testimony. Mr. Greetham, please proceed with your testimony.
Thank you very much. Chairman Schatz, Vice Chairwoman Murkowski, and honorable members of the committee. My name is Stephen Greetham.
Look at this bitch sitting right there beside us. Look at these.
Thank you for the opportunity to speak today. The committee called this hearing to inquire as to freed person descendants' tribal citizenship rights under various 1866 treaties. For Chickasaw, this inquiry is controlled by Article 3 of our 1866 treaty, a treaty to which the Choctaw Nation is also a party. The United States Supreme Court adjudicated the committee's question more than a century ago. Consistent with that adjudication, we have not violated, nor are we violating our treaty. But before I go further, let me say plainly, human chattel slavery is a stain on history. It is a stain on the continent's history,
but they yet they still doing it,
and on Chickasaw history. Likewise, Jim Crow is a stain in the United States and Oklahoma's history. There's no room for ambiguity on those points, and nothing I say today should be interpreted as suggesting any ambiguity. Relevant to the committee's inquiry, the Chickasaw Nation's 1866 treaty provides for a land cession to the United States, but conditions federal compensation on the nation's choosing to extend citizenship to freed persons. That choice was neither made nor supplanted by the treaty, which only spoke to the consequence of whichever choice the Chickasaw made. The Chickasaw people deliberated and chose not to extend citizenship. In doing so, the Chickasaw expressly relinquished any claim to compensation for the lands the United States took.
Wow.
This choice was not a violation of the treaty, but its implementation. And of course, as the Supreme Court.
Okay, damn, that's the, okay, they go their sister right there. Okay, she's Chickasaw, I remember her. So this is Stephen. Stephen is senior counsel of the Chickasaw Nation, Oklahoma City, Oklahoma.
Recently quipped, history did not stop in 1866. In the wake of restored treaty relations, the U.S. again broke faith. Giving in to non-Native political pressure, Congress turns to undermining tribal self-government and opening indigenous lands to non-Native settlement so Oklahoma could be formed as a brand new state.
It should be remembered that throughout this period, Chickasaws themselves were not U.S. citizens, though they and their rights remained subject to Congress's claim to plenary authority over Indian affairs. In the chaos resulting from this pressure campaign, disputes over freed person rights arose, and in 1902, Congress directed us to court. And by us, I mean the United States and the Chickasaw Nation and the Freedmen and the Choctaw Nation. Here's Congress's language. Authority is hereby conferred on the Court of Claims to determine the existing controversy respecting the relations of the Chickasaw Freedmen to the Chickasaw Nation and the rights of such freedmen in the lands of the Choctaw and Chickasaw Nations under the third article of the Treaty of 1866.
I have something to say. Y'all know why these people are doing what they're doing? Because niggas are still trying to join these tribes as if the natives are the first and your ass is second class. This is why this is still going on. Instead of niggas finding out that they're the original and going back into their own motherfucking nation, they're still trying to be a part of some bullshit that really has never existed. These are corporations.
Empress, you're absolutely correct, because when I found my grandmother on the Baker and Henderson Rolls, these people told me, but join the Choctaws. Hell no. For what? To be under jurisdiction of the Title 25?
Yes, to be part of a lie. To be part of a lie. You got anything to say, Clan Mother Mimi?
Well, I'm taking it all in. I'm thinking.
Okay.
I'm thinking on how we can. My mind is on how we can solve this. That's where my head is.
Okay. Do y'all want to listen to some more? Y'all want to continue with this?
You talking about the us don't?
Yeah, it's 4 hours long, Empress.
I don't know how long this is, unless y'all just want to be able to go and listen to it, you know, finish it up. this point is where y'all can, you know, stop it when they get through showing this part. Because I don't know how long this, let me see how long this, because, you're right, it's pretty long. It stops at like 2 hours in. It was pretty long.
I wanted to see what she had to say, Marilyn Vance.
Her radio.
Yeah, you can fast forward it to her. Let me see what she had to say and why she mentioned Africa.
Okay. She like a whole Asian. I don't mean no harm.
Does have a responsibility to the freedmen people as per the treaty.
These not just face motherfuckers.
Tribal chiefs and chairmen.
More.
Now, decisions have been made regarding the status of the freedmen by some tribal nations, and this comes in part after, you know, Jim Crow laws, which put persons of African ancestry on the bottom of the deck here in Oklahoma. As solutions moving forward, where there are some the freedmen have tried to do various things to try to get equity under the treaty. As I said, for instance, there are some Creek freedmen descendants who have been trying to use the federal courts and also the tribal courts. As well as, of course, coming up here to D.C. We would like for the true history of the tribes and the freedmen to be there. So, as I said, you know, that's one reason we're calling for studies, because.
And she's claiming to be a freedman. Is this what she's claiming to be? Stephanie, was it Green? Gritham, and she's claiming to be a freedman. Chief Sunow. Can you hear me, Chief Sunow?
I have a question while we're waiting for Chief Sunow.
Mm-hmm.
Aren't all of these people on this panel U.S. citizens?
I believe so.
U.S. citizens don't have anything to do
with indigenous people.
with nothing.
Nothing. You're not even from here.
Even if they was here, U.S. citizens don't have anything to do with these treaties.
Mm-mm.
Y'all the citizens. Oh, boy. You know, they just pulling our skirt over our head and we holding our skirt. We holding it.
Yep.
Y'all, I got
this is a, her last name may be an Irish last name. I'm looking up all names.
Yeah, they are. Irish. I'm getting tired. I had a fever today but I still want to.
I understand. We can I can share and y'all can go back and watch it. Cause that different. This right here takes a lot out of you.
Because I'm gonna go back and watch it, but I'm give me a couple of days. I'm gonna be listen. We need let's text what days we have to get on that Zoom. I'm not okay. Kidding about that. I'll feel better tomorrow. Pardon me, y'all.
Okay.
I will feel better tomorrow, but we need to go ahead and start something. We can't just keep doing
it. And we can't allow them to keep making these moves on us. And we just sitting idle by like it ain't shit. Like this ain't affecting us because it has affected us more than one way.
You know, they've been getting away with this so long.
Yes.
They bold enough to just break the fucking law in front of our face. That's what I'm looking at.
They want to say what you gonna, and basically say on what you gonna do about it.
They're breaking the law.
Yep.
Right in front of us and expecting us not to do anything because we're so divided. But that's over now, baby. We coming together, Clan Mother.
Yes.
Yes. Yes, we are. We're gonna have to. Ooh, y'all. You know what? I'm so sorry. I wasn't feeling good, but I had to get on here, and I'm kind of wearing me out a little bit. But I'm gonna lay down, and I love y'all.
Love
y'all so much, and I'm
no. We love you too, guys.
I love y'all. Everybody over there on the that's texting. I know I was hard on y'all today, but I do love y'all. But y'all got to get up y'all's asses.
Yes.
Mimi said, "Get up." All right, I love y'all. Talk to you. All right, soon.
Peace and love.
Peace and love, everybody.
All right, I'm gonna play a couple songs before we get out of here, Chief Sun Al. I'll talk to you in the morning or whenever you get up. Just call me.
I sure will.
And we can all go over, you know, some things because we definitely it's time.
That's right.
Keep telling y'all the song. All right, I'm gonna play a couple songs and then we'll get on out of here. Or do you still want to play the video? Did you send it to me in my email?
I sent it to you in your message.
Okay, my message. A manager or?
No, your message that we were talking on and on your phone.
Okay. Hold on. Oh, Lord, I don't know how I'm going to get it. I might have to send it to my email. Wait a minute. Let me see if I can send it to my, it won't allow me to do it. Oh, shit. I said more options to my Gmail. Wait just a second, everyone. Hold on. And then let me see if it went over here. Okay, let me see if I can pull it up now, Chief Sun Al. Wait just a second, everyone. Mail. I just want my mail. Compose no mail, I want my mail. Yeah. Yeah, I hate when this dude did. I'm not even punching nothing. Out of this. And let's add one. Google. Let's see if it'll play. Okay, let me see. Let me share my screen. I'm gonna stop sharing. Let's share again. It's on my Google. This is Chief Sunil's, her goddaughter.
Because I can't.
You can't. It must not let me show it. Because I'm sharing. It's not letting me share. It's not letting me share it to you. It's not letting me show it. I sent it to my email so I could show it.
Right, don't worry about it, Empress. You play your music.
All righty. Let me get back over here and close out some of this mess. Go ahead. We're finna get ready to get out of here. I'm finna play a couple of tunes. And we're gonna get on out of here.
Love and life, family. I'm grabbing a bite to eat, but I love y'all. And it's time for action.
It is. It's time for action. We can't keep playing around because they're not playing around. Let me go over here. And share.
Welcome. Once again, it's time. Yeah.
It's King Isaiah, I'm demanding respect. I see everybody balling till it's time to connect. I see everybody killers till you hand them a check. The cops read them they rights, night sticks to they neck. 2 minutes chasing the check instead of checking priorities. Flexing heavy on the ground, but you still a minority. Fucking whips, your chains, or anything that came after. Misleading black people, you a fucking slave master. This is Genesis, I'm flipping the page back. What's listening to intuition? We ain't got the same pastors. Me, I follow no man, I can't be programmed. This soul food set the mood like a fucking slow jam. It's time to eat time up. To eat up. Toes down, who gon' defeat us? I'm living gold, aboriginal, check my features. Who gon' speak up? I turn up and blow speakers, my own teacher. I grew up with no leaders, can't trust people. Why? Cause they ain't telling the whole truth. Give directions to heaven, but you live in the hell too. That's how I feel, keeping it real, love it or hate it. Either way, they trying to crucify me like the savior. Put thorns in my crown, they knowing that I'm a king. They know. You been crossed too many times, whipped and hung from trees. I am my ancestors from the past that been bled. And now we here resurrected, bitch, I'm back with the dead.
They can't kill me, I'm forever on the rise. They despise my genetics, it's something special about my kind. A descendant of the ones in the tombs. Brown babies coming from wombs in tune with the sun and the moon, you feel me? If it ain't clear, it's time to switch optics. Cause ignorance got us moving in fear, and that bring them big profits. But I'm a prophet, so I kick knowledge. Cause the shit that you hearing on the radio got us misguided. They got our goddesses hate they real bodies, and the gods getting high off lean and pill popping. Bodies are still dropping. Is you paying attention? I guess not. You still paying to listen. I move different in my true image. Just 2 minutes projecting hate. Who gon' lift the whole world up and tell them they great? Everybody getting money, but who's spreading bait? So we can buy back the block, start to better this place. Cause only our skin tones is dark, it's divine mastery. The half moon dome defies gravity, yeah. The real rulers of earth, rebirth humanity. Facts. The queen's high supreme, call her your majesty. Facts. You can battle me, listen, don't be a casualty. Fuck a colonizer, we guardians of the galaxy. They super late. Bitch, I move truth, fuck moving weight. Earth is our true estate, then let our lights illuminate and prosper. I promise I'm passionate with my power. I'm righting all my wrongs and balancing every chakra. Who gon' stop? I'ma get it try. Fucking with the reason you so scared to fly is cause you scared to die. But I exist on dimensions beyond this plane. You thinking it's all a game. When you open up your eyes, your energy start to change. We still traumatized and healing from all the pain. It's good versus evil, our enemies all the same. So I'm 10 toes down with my feet in the dirt. And when I leave Earth, you still hear me speaking this verse. This music is all my scriptures I've been keeping since birth. When I spoke them into existence, I was seeing my work. My purpose is my perspective. I'm serving a higher message. Peace to the Most High. It's written in my genetics. I speak for my soul tribe. We shed a divine essence, releasing the soul ties to whatever we find negative light. Instead of bashing our women, we heal with them. Instead of running from problems, we deal with them. Instead of killing our brothers, we build with them. So fuck that losers. We see in the real picture. We here. It's more spiritual than physical, nigga. If you ain't trying to bring change, you invincible, nigga. For real, my message lives. It's invincible, nigga. And fuck being rich if you ain't got no principles, nigga. Prayer.
Hey, let me say something real quick. All these years we've been calling each other niggas, and they think we tripping. Have our own kind looking at us, we resentment. But listen, you see, we not slaves, but we are the descendants. But this is a new age, so it's time to transition. Nigga means noble individual, grace and godly ambition. Because we always make gold out of the labels that they give us. Because this is our land, we were the first that ever existed. So respect your temple, honor your people. From the motherland to the other lands, we are
indigenous.
Like top of my color, hopped out for my brothers, but I do not think you these hoes understand. And landed the bed when they burned down your channels through niggas and slammers, equality dead. Fuck it, I upped it, came back from my bridge and the threat of my colors, the crown with the feds. Watch how you pacify when you be passing by calling you niggas like calling you dead. Y'all came to the land of the free in the home of the brave, forgot that it's not where you stayed. Start having babies and switching your name around, land on the dies you taking their place. Don't forget Democrats pushing your music back, casting your vocal, put you in the grave. Rewrite your history, filling with misery, lying, told everyone we was the slaves. Where your ancestors from? What name you took on? What boat did you bitches come on? If you had a sponsorship, you not a top Tennessee, but my people been here all along. Calling us African must be an accident. Claiming you American shit is just wrong. Clarification in case you mistaken. Sit back and remember the words to this song. Obama is not American. Mitch McConnell is not American. You crackers is not American. Pan-African is not American. Remember, there's two Americans. We the old, not the new Americans. Man, look how they new Americans. Black people, the true Americans. Sorry, not sorry.
The moment you realize it's people that you love that you gonna have to leave behind.
Y'all put the name of the songs and it's please somebody.
We at war, we at war. Everybody can't go down. Some of us vibing high. Everybody can't go down. Some of y'all might leave family behind. Everybody can't go down. Could've completed, but you get deleted. Some people are defeated, so you feel deleted. And knowledge is medicine, knowing you need it. If everyone go, I'ma know that you treated. You think I'm conceited, I'm feeling completed. Life is a game and I'm planning to beat it. Life is a game and I'm planning to beat it. Everybody can't go though, beat it. You was ascending and starting to win. No pretending, actually win. Low vibrations, box you in. Who keep letting them toxins in? All my people are toxin us. Everyone on our toxin land. Hatred like cosmology. I am the source I go within. I can't go unless I go to win. Really a god supposed to win. Anyone that's trying to get with me, just start doing the most you in. Trying to turn up, it goes to 10. Blood type O, you almost in. Then our kin, we all go in. Amaru, we all go in. Water, but can't make you drink. No, I'm not here to just make you think. If anything, I'm here to just make you fight. It's all lost, just make you right. Everybody ain't with it. Let me tell you, I don't like reading. Freedom ain't free, you broke, I get it. Let me tell you, you don't like breathing. Can't even wake you up, you sleeping. Niggas are sleeping, scalping season. Some of y'all sleep through all this treason. Government beefing, now you vegan. Need autonomy, really don't need them. Now we rock this house, it's freedom. Really gonna hurt my heart to leave them. Really gonna hurt my heart to leave them. This is assimilating or psychos, they be hating on you for survival. That's why I don't mess with the Bible. Ain't nobody tribal going viral. We original, we hold the title. Lot of work to do, how you idle. Ain't no false idols in they bio. We ancient, for ancient in Ohio. Say what you want and do what you do, but I'm starting to get, I don't know about you. Gotta go with them, can't go on YouTube. If you think you know, you ain't got no clue. Say what you want. But I'm starting to get it, I don't know if you do. Gotta go with thinking, go on YouTube. You thinking you know you ain't got no clue. War, we at war. Everybody can't go though. Some of us vibing high. Everybody can't go though. Some of y'all might leave family behind. Everybody can't go though. Could've completed, but you get deleted. Some people are defeated, so you feel needed. And knowledge is medicine, knowing you need it. If everyone go, I'ma know that you cheated. You think I'm conceited, I'm feeling completed. Life is a game and I'm planning to beat it. Life is a game and I'm planning to beat it. Gotta be the everybody can't go no beat it.
I'm gonna play one more song and then we out of here.
Message sent yesterday at 5:27 p.m.
I'm tired of how black men being killed. They done put some respect on that damn name.
If I am in the Minneapolis Grand Man, wait, wait. What is he right now? I don't want to handle things the right way. You are not going to talk to me.
I swear it's like a disease that goes round and round and round like Siamese.
Things change.
The evil that money brings. I swear it's like a disease that goes round and round and round like sirens. And they wanna bury me. Why? Cause I'm anti-everything. I swear it's like a disease that goes round and round and round like sirens.
Man, I'm anti-dirty cops, anti-bullshit, I'm anti-scamming-ass preachers in the pulpit, I'm anti-no truth, anti-full of lies, I'm anti-scared to try, I'm anti-scared to die, I'm anti-poverty, anti-stay the same, I'm anti-hard lies, anti-scared to change, I'm anti-pity parties, anti-excuse makers, anti-lazy niggas, anti-truth haters, anti-pray and march, I'm anti-quiet nigga, Malcolm over Martin, I ain't anti-violent nigga, anti-fake rope. Anti-underwear, I'm anti-Jesus Christ, I'm anti-church and prayer, I'm anti-false hope, anti-Holy Ghost, I'm anti-fairy tales, brainwashing grown folks, I'm anti-Jesus letting killers in the church up, and God ain't doing shit, watching as we get murked out, I'm anti-hands too wide to open their eyes and see, I'm anti-loving my enemies and apologies, I'm anti-gangbang music, helping kill the youth and drug overdose music, targeted to me and you, I'm anti-black cops, signing why they killing us. Black judges hugging the killer, but they ain't helping us. I'm anti-scared to fight, anti-scared to leave. Malcolm said won't be no revolution, cause I'm scared to bleed. I'm anti-no proof, anti-no evidence, anti-niggas not asking questions, just leaving shit. I'm anti-begging to the sky, my situation's hard. I trust and I believe. believe in me. I'm anti-belief in God. I'm anti even on this earth hating racism. Anti-hateful whites. I'm anti-niggas, nigga. Anti-genocide. Sick pain and suffering. If it don't help to better us, I'm anti-everything.
The evil that money brings. I swear it's like a disease that goes round and round and round like sirens.
And before you bury me, cause I'm anti-everything.
I swear it's like a disease that goes round and round and round like sirens.
I see the strangest things.
The evil that money brings. I swear it's like a disease that goes round and round and round like sirens.
And I'm anti-roots, nigga, anti-fake truth. I'm anti-believing the slavery stories taught at school. I'm anti that we are from Africa, don't apply to me. I'm anti-Kanye rocking our people back to sleep. I'm anti-granny killers, grandsisters had the truth. I'm anti-monkey shit, I'm anti-Lucy too. I'm anti-letting these white folks tell me just who I am. My granny came from right here, nigga, she was an Indian. I'm anti-getting scammed, anti-getting played. I'm pro-genealogy, I'm anti-DNA, I'm anti-refusing to checking the shit that he was saying. I'm anti-believing the white man and not what granny say. Niggas ain't like it when Walker came dropping facts in. He said he wasn't black and he ain't African-American. That's real talk, real spiel, real life, real deal. I'm anti-hurriness, my mission is to help him. Anti-ignorance, anti-religious shit. I'm anti-cool when niggas cognitive dissonance. I'm anti-lacking knowledge, put us at a disadvantage. Anti-social with niggas fighting for a chicken sandwich. Anti-flint water, anti-sucker shit. And fuck you to them blacks that's selling out for the government. I'm anti-no planning, anti-folk scamming. Anti-no will, I'm anti-low standards. Anti-no drive, anti-low lives. Anti-no esteem, I'm anti-no pride. Anti-wanna quit, I'm anti-giving up. I'm anti-niggas not helping to lift our people up. I'm anti-hating niggas, anti-lame niggas. Anti-6ix9ine, I'm anti snake niggas, anti-no vibe. Live like fly high. Some days it's gonna be full of rain, the other days the sun will shine.
The evil that money brings. I swear it's like a disease. Go round and round and round like sirens. And we pull the bury me, cause I'm anti-everything. I swear it's like a disease that goes round and round and round like sirens.
And a man was shot and killed inside the chapel at this World Changers Church International. A man, a worker at the church, leading a prayer, opening the prayer service today. And as the longtime member who talked to Karen indicated, there were a lot of people who did that prayer service on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays at 10. Different people lead the service. But as he was leading the prayer at the start of the service, a man walked up to him and shot and killed him. Shot him at point blank range.
I'm going to play one more song, y'all, before I get out of here. Then I'm out. Peace, love, and light. Everybody have a masterful rest of the night. We'll let y'all know when we do get everything together. Not gonna do it on the internet on here where they can see what we're talking about, but we'll definitely reach out. So Chisa now we'll get it together. I guess she said if y'all can call a 1-800 number.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I ain't here to judge, I just want you to walk with me. So miss me with all envy, cause shit could get dark quickly. I'm swimming with the sharks, they wishing that jaws get me. What I speak, it shall exist, that's the spirit of God in me. Listen, I'm trying to tell them that it's deeper than rap. I'm trying to bring them back, the ones that fell deep in the trap. See, they feed you the bullshit, but then be keeping the facts. Spreading white lies by trying to tell our people they black. I know my lineage, I spit the truth in any booth you sit me in. Connected to the higher power, I know why it sent me here. To open eyes and show that hope it lies within your mind. Cause this globe is ours, so let's take over now. You know it's time, cause they control the blind. Lost, so they can't see what's going down. Yeah, you might can take the gold, but you can't break the golden chime. Now, all my kings worldwide, I know that they gon' hold it down. Come by. Then they firing straight out the holster. And I've been having premonitions. See, it's time for us to stand up and unite.
You feel me? Because a lot of people say that you gotta see it to believe it. You feel me? But from my perspective, I look at it as sometimes we gotta believe it to see it. Start with you, you feel me? Fellas, I've been having premonitions of my niggas winning. Building up the projects free from penitentiary.
See it.
And we all unified. There ain't no senseless killers. I'm glad we finally realized that we ain't really different. We finally get that we in fact all kings, so we subtract all beef. We growing crops in every block, look like Black Wall Street. And we investing in these stocks so we can stack our cream. And we ready for war if you try and snatch our dreams. Revolution, we abide by our principles, making changes. Street niggas turn scholars. Knowledge is really gangster. We protectors and providers. We gotta uplift the nation for our queens. We ride if you try to put them in danger. Yeah, beneath the chaos, know your soul is pure. All that greatness you got within was never shown before. Wherever you take your crown, that's your home for sure. So why beef over the block when the world is yours, indigenous?
At one point, I was ignorant and lost, but like you gotta know your soul, so you ain't done, or you can make a breath, or you can have a chance, you gotta know yourself. So we don't got no means to go get these niggas got $1 million. Set up, like the LAPD, like the Fed, like the FBI. All this is they army. And they army making sure you can split your will. Meaning if a motherfucker don't want to do it from an agreement, you can come take it. If a nigga don't want to agree and do it verbally, we got an army to come enforce your will. So we that's what we lack. You know what I mean? We don't have no army that's gonna come protect our natural resources. Because our shit is the body. How, you know what I'm saying? We don't even understand how we connect. That's
a fucked up mentality. Peace, love, and light, everyone. Everybody have a masterful rest of the evening. We'll let y'all know. I know Zoe want to do a live soon, so I'm going to have to reach out to him and see what day he want to do the
watch
live.
This. I can show you how to get but, the sweetest deals
yes,
online.
Everybody have a masterful rest of the evening. Much love and respect to everyone. Thanks for lending us your energy tonight.